From Aloha Stadium, K-5, the home team presents University of Hawaii Warrior Football. With their Western Athletic Conference schedule behind them and a Hawaii Bowl appearance a month away, the Warriors turn their attention to tonight's matchup against the Purdue Boilermakers of the Big Ten. Hello again, everybody. I'm Jim Leahy. And when you look at this game, it all of a sudden has turned into the most important game of the year. After all, Hawaii has struggled all year long. They've been successful all year long to get nationally ranked. Well, with a victory over San Jose State last week, they are now nationally ranked. And they are going to prove their mettle tonight, to prove their worth against a team from a power conference, Purdue. Purdue comes in here and they are 8-4. They were 5-3 in the conference. And despite the fact that they did not play because of scheduling rotation, they did not play number 2 Michigan or number 1 Ohio State, Purdue still has a very potent team, especially when they throw the ball. Working with me again tonight is Jim Donovan. Purdue comes in. They're from a power conference. Hawaii has been waiting for this kind of game all year long.
Well, Purdue's offense starts with Curtis Painter, Jim. He's got 17 touchdowns on 16 interceptions this year. And even when he doesn't play well, like last week when he had 4 interceptions against Indiana, Purdue was still good enough to win the old Oaken Bucket. When he's looking to throw the ball around, the first person he'll throw it to is Selwyn Lyman, who's got legit 4-4 speed and has torched Notre Dame earlier this year for 238 yards. Another person he looks to throw to is Dorian Bryant, the leading receiver with 71 catches. And the other person I look for him to throw to tonight, probably more than usual, is a converted wide receiver to tight end Dustin Keller with 49 catches. On defense, their team leaders are Anthony Spencer, who has 10.5 sacks and 4 forced fumbles. And backing him up at linebacker is Dan Bick, the team's leader with 87 tackles. As you said, Jim, both these offenses are potent. I look for a lot of scoring tonight.
That could be. That could very well be. Purdue comes in with Curtis Painter as the quarterback. Curtis Painter leads the Big Ten in total offense. But he is up against a quarterback tonight in Colt Brennan, who leads the nation in total offense, 403 yards a game. Working with me again tonight is Russell Yamanoha. Glad you made it, Russell, because it is a traffic jam outside of Aloha Stadium
tonight. Yeah, big crowd on hand tonight, and the traffic is brutal. They should see a pretty good ball game tonight between Hawaii and Purdue because, as you said, this is a huge game for Hawaii. Both of these teams already have bowl bids locked up. Hawaii go to the Hawaii Bowl, Purdue to the Champ Sports Bowl. But for Hawaii, respect is the big word tonight. If they come out, especially with a newly found national ranking, and stumble against this Purdue squad, that's just going to lend to the detractors to say, Hawaii plays a whack schedule, and that's just the kind of season they had. If they can come out and get a win here against the Boilermakers, boy, that will just leapfrog them as far as respect goes, especially heading into next week's game against Oregon State. I mean, let's face it, for Hawaii to have a big amount of respect for next season and be considered among the top teams in the country, they need to run the table here, and it starts with Purdue for this Hawaii team.
When we come back, we'll get things underway. It is Purdue of the Big Ten against Hawaii of the Western Athletic Conference.
This exclusive sports presentation of the home team is sponsored by Hawaiian Telcom. From local to long distance, wireless to internet, Hawaiian Telcom has solutions for all of your communication needs. Hawaiian Telcom, keeping Hawaii connected.
This injury report is sponsored by HMSA, working for a healthier Hawaii. And wouldn't you know it, Purdue, close to the vest. Hawaii, very close to the vest. No injuries reported. There was a flu bug during practice for Hawaii this week, but that has dissipated, and the team is at 100%. Let's take a look now at the keys to the game, sponsored by Kaiser Permanente. Thrive.
The first key to the game is pass protection. Painter and Brennan both can be awesome if given the time. But you've got defensive coordinators Jerry Glanville and the Warriors' best lineman Mel Purcell. And you've got the Purdue defensive coordinator Brock Spack and their best lineman Anthony Spencer going to do everything they can to disrupt the quarterback. We'll see if the O-lines are up to the task.
For Hawaii, they need to come out and seize the moment. This is going to be a big game tonight for this Warriors squad as far as national respect goes. They've been beaten up on the competition. all year long, but now the competition gets markedly better, and the 8-4 Purdue Boilermakers in Hawaii can win a lot of respect across the country. People are going to be logging onto their computers to check top 25 scores. They're going to see Hawaii on there, and if Hawaii can pull off a win here tonight, that will go a long way towards pushing this team into higher levels.
Hawaii has played only one team in a BCS conference this year. That was the opener against Alabama. Hawaii losing that game 25-17. One of only two losses on the season. Hawaii comes in 9-2. They've been able to win 8 in a row. Take a look at Joe Tiller in his 10th season, 75-47. Joe Tiller earlier this week said he didn't want to play this game. He doesn't want to play 13 games. He doesn't like the distance. He doesn't like the flight time. He doesn't like being away at Thanksgiving. He didn't like the officials. So the officials tonight are not from the Western Athletic Conference. They're from the Pac-10. So he just kept excuse after excuse why he didn't want to play this game. But it comes down to 13 games. He doesn't want to play 13 games. And he tried to get out of it. He talked to his athletic department chairman, the athletics director, and he couldn't. At least they showed up. Dan Kelly will kick off for Hawaii. Purdue winning the toss and electing to receive. Dorian Bryant deep for Purdue, number 9. Also, Torrey Williams, number 2, back deep. So this game, before the biggest crowd of the season here at Aloha Stadium. Now Corey Sheets has come in. And he is deep for Purdue. It will go halfway into the end zone for Dorian Bryant, and he will not return it. Purdue is led by quarterback Curtis Painter, 6'4", 228-pound junior from Vincennes, Indiana, 263 of 452 in passing. 17 touchdowns. He has 6 interceptions. And there you see his yards, 3,364. He leads the Big Ten in total offense, 291 yards per game. And he also leads the Big Ten in passing, 280 yards per game. First down. Sheets is back in the shotgun with Painter. They will throw. With time, throws. That is complete to Lyman. Selwyn Lyman, 6'4", sophomore out of Fort Wayne, Indiana. That is his 29th catch of the year. Jacob Patek was there to make the tackle. Tonight's starting lineup, sponsored by Enjoy Snacks. It's time to enjoy life. There is the starting offense. Bryant, of course, with the receptions. And Sheets on the ground. Sheets with 730 yards rushing. Again, the shotgun with two backs. Ball is given with a short gain. Ball is given to Sheets. And Sheets short of the first down. Solomon Elamimian and Adam Leonard there to make the stop for Hawaii. Here are the starters for Hawaii on defense. And of particular interest is Mel Purcell. Purcell comes in with 49 total tackles, 7.5 sacks. He had 3.5 sacks last week against San Jose State. And he is a bulwark, third down and one. Ball resting on the 29-yard line. Again, it is given to Sheets, and he may have the first down, and then again, he may not. It depends where they put the ball. Elamimian and Leonard there to make the stop for Hawaii as they double-team him. It is enough for the first down.
All that ball has to do is touch the line, and it's a first down, and that's where they marked it.
Boy, they give him a good spot on that one.
Point of the ball just at the 30-yard line, first down. Lyman is to the far side, and to the near side is Greg Orton, the wide receiver. Ball is given again to Sheets. And Sheets, on a very short game, gets thrown back by the black shirts. Adam Leonard, the leading tackler for Hawaii. Leonard coming into this game with 89 tackles, and he does have that fumble return for a touchdown against New Mexico State earlier in the year. Here's another look.
You can see a nice job there. Michael Lafaele does a really nice job. Linebacker creeps in there to help make the tackle. They're running zone block. The Boilermakers are running a zone block.
Second down. Painter throws. That is incomplete. Intended for Kyle Adams, the tight end. And that will bring up third down for Purdue.
That was a complete misdirection. You had all the Boilermaker offensive linemen running to their left, and the play was going back to the right. So that's meant just to confuse the defense. Nice job by the Warriors covering it.
Third down and about 7.5 for Purdue. Bryant and the linemen are to the far side. Orton sets up as a wide receiver to the near side. Sheets and Taylor in the shotgun with Painter. Painter on third down. Now throws. That is incomplete. Nobody really there. It was intended for Bryant. And Hawaii had coverage all over the place. They had him surrounded. Leonard Peters was the closest for Hawaii to the ball. And Devon Best now has come in to run back the punt. First punt of the game. And the punter is Jarrett Armstrong. This is his 48th punt, 42.6 average. Second in the Big Ten. Excellent punt. Excellent. Best takes it on the 16. Gets a block at the 20. Best at the 27-yard line. Still on his feet. Finally succumbs to the pressure right there. We'll pause along the network. Hawaii and Purdue just underway. The last college football game of this Saturday. Hawaii will have the ball at their own 28, their first possession of the game. Colt Brennan, the quarterback, leads the nation in pass efficiency, leads the nation in total offense, 403 yards per game. He comes in with 4,155 yards in passing, 48 touchdowns, and only 8 interceptions. Chad Mock, Devon Best, are flanked to the left. Also joining them is Ryan Bryce Mullins. Ilawa. Number four, back with Brennan in the shotgun. Brennan on first down. Looking, throws. That's complete. And the ball is advanced to the 31-yard line by Chad Mock. Mock making his 20th catch of the year. He comes in with 292 yards. Offensive starters for Hawaii. And Vess, who comes into this game with 922 yards. In the pass receiving, Ilawa comes in with 10 touchdowns rushing and 5 touchdowns receiving. So Hawaii, just an offensive juggernaut over the course of this season. Mock in motion. Second down and 2. Shovel pass. This is Ilawa. First down and more to the 44-yard line. Here's the defense for Purdue. And Purdue has a real outstanding player in Anthony Spencer. Spencer second in tackles on the team, but he is first in the country in tackles for loss, 26.5, and he comes in with 10.5 sacks. And also joining him is Cliff Avril in statistics. Avril comes in with a total of 5 sacks, third in tackles, and in tackles for loss, minus 62 yards on the season. First down for Hawaii at their own 44-yard line. Brennan hands the ball to Ilawa. And Ilawa slides into the secondary from the 44 to about the 47. Dan Bick there to make the stop for Hawaii, 6'1 junior out of Louisville, Kentucky. Leading tackler on this team with 87 coming in. He also has one interception. So Hawaii moving the ball. They started at their own 28-yard line, and now they have advanced it to the 47. Second down. And a long 6. Triple wide receiver to the right. Brennan. Looking. Throws. That is complete. It is complete to Chad Mock. On the 41-yard line. That's enough for a first down. 10-yard gain.
Purdue that time comes with a mini blitz. Try to get them pressure on Colt Brennan. He just gets rid of it lightning fast, finds Mock right out here on their sideline, And Hawaii's going to nickel and dime them all night long if the defensive backs for the Boilermakers keep playing off like that.
Royce Adams made the stop for the Boilermakers. First down for Hawaii on the Purdue 41-yard line. First possession of the game for Hawaii. Ball again is given to Ilawa. Turns the corner. 30. And Ilawa ushered out of bounds at the 27. Gain on the play of 14 and a first down for Hawaii. Nate Ilawa. Ilawa now has gone over 700 yards in rushing.
This is something that the Warriors actually worked on this week. It's called Tampa Crack, where the outside receiver comes in and cracks down on the outside linebacker or the strong safety. Nice job there
by Ian Sample. First down for Hawaii. Ball is at the 27, just outside the 27 of Purdue. Bryce Mullins in motion. Triple wide receiver to the left. Brennan looking left with time. Still looking. Comes back to the near side. Now throws. Touchdown! Ryan Bryce Mullins. We have a penalty flag. Preliminary indication, illegal man downfield.
Ineligible receiver downfield. Offense number 72.
Well, Jim and Russ, the most interesting thing so far this evening is that the Boilermakers are actually playing in a nickel defense, and they've only got three defensive linemen. Pretty much every game this year, they've played with four down linemen. But I guess they took a close look at the San Jose State first three quarters last week and decided to try it with three down linemen and five backs. We'll see if they make any adjustments right here. They just sent in some new players.
Yeah, the Hawaii offensive line been doing a great job all season long of picking up blitz packages. And pretty much the defense is facing this Hawaii offense. Just kind of give up on trying to get to Colt. Play some defensive backs back there, try to stop these receivers. That play didn't work even though with a lead old man downfield.
Line of scrimmage following that penalty back to the 32-yard line. In motion is Sample. Ball is pitched to Mauia, Reagan Mauia, but he drops it. That'll go as an incomplete pass. Mauia going into the game, replacing Ilawa.
And as sure as I pointed it out, they went back to their regular four-man D-line front for that last play. Incomplete.
That'll bring up second down and 15 from the 32.
Well, they're just switching it up now. They're going back and forth, the five backs and four backs, trying to keep Colt on his toes and maybe the receiver's off balance. We'll see where this goes.
Triple wide receiver to the left. Ball is given. Turning the corner is Ilawa. The 20. Head butts his way to the 16-yard line. That's enough for a first down. 18-yard gain. And that play, even though this game is just underway, is paying huge dividends for the Warriors.
Well, you can see whenever a defense goes into a three-down front against the Warriors, they're very successful running that Tampa right. And right there, it was very successful. You can see Hercules Satelli's pulling there, getting a nice block. The receiver getting a nice block. Pretty much all the running room in the world for Nasty Nate Ilawa.
So Ilawa running well early in the game. And the ball is advanced to the 16 of Purdue. Brennan steps up in the pocket, throws off the hands of Ian Sample in the end zone. He was covered by Dan Bick deep.
Purdue gets down inside the red zone. Hawaii gets down inside the red zone, I should say. And Purdue kind of uses the back of the end zone as an extra defender. They go with four defensive linemen on that play. As you look at the pass, go to Sample. And he'll tell you, he should have had that one. That was a sure touchdown, but it's in and out of his hands. It's up to second and 10.
Six defensive backs now for Purdue. Second down. The ball is at the 16. Brennan throws. That's complete at the 10-yard line to Jason Rivers. Rivers inside the 5 to about the 3, and that's enough for a first down and an 11-yard gain.
Well, the Boilermakers trying to do anything possible to get to Colt Brennan.
you'll see that the they ran a twist right there. Number 79 coming around on the end of his twist. They're just doing everything they can to get to the quarterback.
Boy, Jason Rivers just laying the lumber on Aaron Lane. Hawaii's been fighting for respect all season long. Now they're fighting for it in this game on man-to-man matchups. Jason Rivers won that one over Aaron Lane right there.
Let's go, defense!
Hawaii comes out first down and goal to go. The motion is mocked. This is Ilawa with a block. Ilawa, touchdown!
I tell you what, this is the largest crowd that we've had all year. There's got to be 40 plus in here, maybe as much as 45, and they're very happy right now.
On two or three times on this drive, we've seen Hawaii players just run over Boilermaker defenders. That time, Brandon Irvin gets run over by Ilawa, and he takes it into the end zone. And boy, this crowd is being heard from.
Tack on the extra point. And it's Brian Forrester kicking the point after. 8:24 left to play in the first quarter. Hawaii leading 7-0 over Purdue. Central Pacific Bank sponsors the loyalty award by donating $100 toward the Central Pacific Bank endowed scholarship fund for every touchdown Hawaii scores. Central Pacific Bank, member of the FDIC. Fiercely loyal banking. 4-yard touchdown run, 72 yards, 10 plays for Hawaii. 3 minutes, 26 seconds in elapsed time. On that drive, Ilawa, by the way, 47 yards. Just in gobbling up real estate. Kickoff goes to Dorian Bryant. Bryant at the 15. Bryant trying to break into the clear. He can't do it. He gets out over the 25. Dan Kelly, the kicker, able to tackle him there. So good return. Excellent return that time by Sheets. Rather, excuse me, by Bryant.
In that last series, the record was broken by Colt Brennan on the season total offense. The record was 44-57 by Timmy Chang in 2002. Now it's 44-95 by Colt Brennan.
First down, the ball at the 28. Painter hands the ball off. With it is Sheets. Runs into his own blocker. And then Jacob Patek from the secondary able to make the tackle. And a good gain on first down for Purdue. And Corey Sheets. Sheets comes into this game with 730 yards. He has scored 21 touchdowns. And he is eighth on the all-time Purdue list. Last year, he was honorable mention freshman All-America. Painter comes out with five wide receivers. An empty backfield. It's just Painter. Away with a four-man front. Second down and long three. Ball at the 34. Painter, quick pass. That's complete. No, it's not. Unable to bring it in was Jason Taylor. Taylor had turned to go upfield, but he didn't have possession of the ball, and the ball escaped. That'll bring up third down.
Boy, Painter puts this one right on the money. It's just one of those where Taylor just thought about it too much. He was open on the play, just thought about it too much and let it go.
Lyman and Orton are the wide receivers, and Bryant slotted to the left. Third down and three. Painter steps up, now throws. That is incomplete. That was intended for Bryant. The ball was thrown inside of him. Hawaii was in double coverage, but that ball should have been completed because Bryant was open. He was unable to make contact. That'll bring a fourth down.
It almost looks like Curtis Painter might be doing something wrong mechanically when he's making his throw because he's had two of his passes get away from him so far this evening. There's only 8 minutes elapsed in the first quarter. That's a little unusual for him.
Armstrong in to punt. And another beauty. Bess inside the 20. Takes it at the 14. Eludes one man. He's at the 20. Gets a block. And it gets tackled from behind at the 25. 52-yard punt and a 10-yard return. When we come back, Hawaii goes back to work on offense. 6:55 left to play in the first quarter. And Hawaii leading 7-0.
11, not 10 reasons why Hawaii Self Storage is your best storage value. Hi.
You're taking a look at the Purdue head coach Joe Till. He's been here twice before to Hawaii as head coach of the Wyoming Cowboys. His thoughts on playing Hawaii. In our Geico quote of the game, he's got a bunch of quotes. And if you're a Purdue Boilermaker player, you got to be thinking, Coach, what's up? He says, I never wanted this game, and I still don't. As Jim said, he went on to say it's a difficult place to go and play. I told our AD to call Hawaii and tell them we're not coming. We're just not coming. Go find another opponent. The humidity is high. The heat index is such that it's a challenge for our team to stay hydrated. Well, this guy just wants no part of Hawaii.
First down for Hawaii at the 25-yard line. They lead 7-0. Brennan looking with time. Throws. That is complete at the 45-yard line. A tiptoeing out of bounds is Devon Bess. 22-yard gain and a first down. And Colt Brennan, gentlemen, had all day.
Plays like this is the reason why Joe Tiller didn't want to come out and face this Hawaii team. Devon Bess just makes it look so easy with this battering mate, Colt Brennan. There's another one for Joe Tiller. He said, I think our guys are in good spirits. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. Boy, if you're a Purdue football player and you hear your coach talking like that,
a psychological defeat.
Bess in motion. First down at the 47-yard line for Hawaii, their own 47. Brennan again steps up in the pocket, throws. That is complete to the 30, to the 25. Jason Rivers inside the 20-yard line. 36-yard gain.
The Warrior receivers are doing a very nice job of sliding in between the zone backs for the Boilermakers. Those last two pass plays with a nice gain, so Colt's putting it right on the money. The Boilermakers need to do something, either tighten up those zones or think about going man-to-man.
Well, maybe allow us to stay back in the blitz pickup. Nobody came. He stood back there looking for somebody to hit. Colt Brennan still had all the time in the world, and right now Purdue has no answers for this Hawaii offense.
Brennan with all kinds of time. That offensive line, just a curtain. Lays it off. With it is Ilawa. And Ilawa gets inside the 15-yard line. The line of scrimmage being the 17th short game that time.
You know, that last play showed how much Colt Brennan's matured since the beginning of this season till this game. Earlier in the season, he might have tried to force that into the end zone or try to get more out of it. And now he appropriately just dumps it off to Nate and let Nate pick up 5 yards on it. It was a great job by Colt.
Second down, the ball at the 13. This is the kind of range that Brennan likes to go to the end zone for the score. Let's see if he does it here. Triple wide receiver to the right. Brennan, again with time, throws. That is complete to Bryce Mullins, but an excellent play that time by the defensive secondary, Terrell Vinson. Vinson the corner. And the game very short.
Amazingly enough, Ian Sample might have been open for a touchdown right there. He was the one player to cut across the middle as the other two cut to the outside. And with Colt, doesn't really matter. He could probably hit all three of them.
So Hawaii has the ball just outside the Purdue 10-yard line. They are leading in this game, 7-0. 4:47 left to play in the first quarter. Ilawa and Brennan in the I formation. Brennan looking right, and he gives the shovel pass that time to Ilawa, and they were waiting for it. Boy, they ambushed him at the line of scrimmage. Excellent defensive play by Purdue.
Mike McDonald and Ryan Baker just smelled that play out, Jim. And June's got to think about how often he wants to run that one, because it seems like they practiced that quite a bit.
Hawaii now faces fourth down and 3. And apparently they are going to talk things over here, whether they will go for the possession or whether they will go for the touchdown or whether they will go for the field goal. They have to go, when you're talking possession, to keep it, they have to go to just outside the 7-yard line for the first down.
Well, if you're Hawaii here, you got to go for it. You're against a Big Ten team at home. Your first game is a nationally ranked team. You got nothing to lose. You already got your bowl bid locked up. Go for it. Which is probably one of the reasons why Joe Tiller didn't want to play this game, because for Purdue, they're looking at it as, what do you gain out of it? That's what Joe Tiller said. For Hawaii, they got everything to gain.
Well, you know, the Big Ten has that rep. It's the heartland of football in the country. And he's 8-4 in the Big Ten this year. Coming out here to play Hawaii, as you said, Russ, after already getting the Champ Sport Bowl locked up, you got to think to yourself, if you're the head coach, well, what good does it do if you win? Only sort of hurts your program if you lose.
He just doesn't want to play the 13th game. He said that's just too many games.
And he saw what happened to Michigan State and Northwestern a couple of years ago when Hawaii needed that late season run and got it against a couple of Big Ten teams. Big play for Hawaii on 4th-and-3.
They overload the left side now with wide receivers, Ilawa and Brennan on 4th down. Do they convert? They do. No, incomplete. Best could not keep the ball. Best was open. See how the ball was thrown this time.
Very uncharacteristic for Devon Best and for the Warriors, who are 90% scoring in the red zone. And I think he might have tried to run there before he actually caught the ball. And oftentimes that's what happens, the ball goes to your hands.
It's a little bit of adrenaline rush for Devon Best trying to move the ball upfield before he secured it away.
So away now, 7-for-18 in 4th down conversions. That gives Purdue an opportunity to come back here. 3:52 left to play in the first quarter. Painter hands the ball to Sheets. And Sheets, the line of scrimmage being the 10-yard line, Sheets advances it to about the 13. Michael Lau there to make the tackle for Hawaii out of Honolulu and Kamehameha. 5'9", 218-pound junior.
I got to tell you, Jim, Michael Lafaele is just playing excellent tonight. He was double-teamed on that play, and they moved him maybe a half a yard. That's just a great job.
2nd down for Purdue. Ball on the 13. Painter from the shotgun. Drops back inside. The 5 throws. That is complete. Out over the 20 to the 22-yard line. That was Greg Orton. For Orton, that was his 47th reception of the season. And that's a 12-yard gain for Purdue.
Well, that time, Mike Otto, the left tackle, did a great job of stemming the rush. And Kaikalama Francis put a spin move on him, and Otto just ran him into the pile, into the line of scrimmage, and that gave Painter enough time to get the ball out of there.
1st down, just short of the 23 for Purdue. The motion is Bryant. Ball is fumbled by Bryant. Picked up by Bryant. Whistle blows. Penalty flag. Here's Jack Wood.
Prior to the snap, false start. Offense.
False start on Purdue.
5-yard penalty remains 1st down.
Joe Tiller against Hawaii in his coaching lifetime is 4-2. This is the first time that he has faced Hawaii as the coach of Purdue, but he did face Hawaii 6 times as coach of Wyoming. 1st and 15 for Purdue. Purdue with triple wide receiver to the left. Bryant comes into the backfield. And the ball again is given to Sheets, but we will have another penalty flag. So Purdue having some timing problems here.
Prior to the snap, false start. Offense, number 28, 5-yard penalty remains.
Well, I think
down.
On the play before, they had 2 men in motion at the same time. In that play, they weren't set long enough before they snapped the ball.
So now it is still 1st down, but it is 1st and 20. And the ball back at the 12-yard line. And they come out in the Hawaii offense. 4 wides, and with that tight end, it could be 5 wides. Ball is given up the middle, and with it is Sheets. And Sheets is run into by Adam Leonard. Sheets started to step into that secondary. He had visions of a big game, and Leonard cut him off. Leonard out of Seattle, the 6-foot sophomore, 236-pound linebacker, and he can hit.
Sheets tries to put on a nice spin move right there, but Adam holds on to him long enough for the rest of his friends to get there.
Second down and 17. Ball on the 15-yard line. Curtis Painter, the quarterback for Purdue. Painter lays it off. This is complete. And with it is Sheets. Sheets gets to the 20, still very short of the first down. Jacob Patek halted his progress. And that will bring up third down. And it will be third down and about, let's see, third and 12. Score from USC and Notre Dame, and the Irish take it on the chin.
Well, that hurts Michigan's chance for an argument to be able to play Ohio State again.
Next week, USC plays UCLA. Third down and 12. Painter keeps it. Throws long over the middle. That is complete to the tight end. That is complete to Dustin Keller for the first down. If one thing Hawaii has had trouble with, that is the tight ends on all the teams that they played this season. 22-yard game.
You see the Warriors bring all four linebackers. That means they got to be in man-to-man coverage. And the tight end was able to break in towards the center away from his man and make that completion.
Would have made a nice catch of a two on a low thrown ball.
Dustin Keller.
Purdue, 46% in third down conversions for the season. First down at their own 42-yard line on a sweep. This is Bryant into the secondary and into Hawaii territory. All the way to the 47. Excellent run and a variation on the theme that time by Purdue. Giving it on a sweep to Bryant. Michael Lafayette following the play, finally tackled him.
Good news, bad news for Lafayette. He's a nose guard, 300-pounder. He's in pursuit. That's the good news. The bad news, he gets carried by Dorian Bryant, who goes 5'10", 175. And Purdue's starting to find a groove here after having some struggles on their first couple of series.
That will be the last play of the first quarter. Hawaii leading 7-0. But Purdue, all of a sudden, reaching out to seize some momentum. And they have a drive going.
It's hard.
After next week's game, each of the Warrior seniors will be presented with a plaque from the University of Hawaii Federal Credit Union. The University of Hawaii Federal Credit Union's Ariel Chun will make the presentation to honor each senior's commitment and success as a University of Hawaii student athlete. That's after the Oregon State game next week. We begin the second period, and for the first time, offensively, we are seeing some consistency by a Purdue of the Big Ten. And they have this drive continuing into Hawaii territory on the 47, where it is first and 10. Cheech is the tailback in the shotgun behind Painter. Wide receivers left and right. Double tight end. Ball is kept by Painter. Throws long, and the receiver was open. That was Lyman. Coming over was Jacob Patek, and Patek got there just in time. He confused Lyman enough, so it went as an incomplete pass.
Boy, Painter picked the wrong side of the field that time because Greg Orton was locked up with Gerard Lewis all by himself and pretty much running wide open that time. Jacob Patek, the ball hung up just enough for him to get out there and make the play off of Lyman. Barely gets there.
Not to mention Michael Out almost got to him in the backfield.
So it will be second down and 10. Officials looking toward the clock. And the play clock may not have moved on that last play.
There's a malfunction of the 25-second clock. The 25-second play count will be kept on the field of play.
.14:55 remaining to be played in the first half. So the 25-second clock to be held on the field. A malfunction. Orton and Bryant come to the near side. sweep to Sheets with Fleckers. Gets to the outside, down the sideline to the 30. And Sheets is rolled out of bounds, and here comes a penalty flag. Excellent play again that time by Purdue. 20-yard gain for Sheets.
And Jake Standifer, the receiver out on the edge, got into a block with one Hawaii defender. It caused enough of a traffic jam that that allowed Sheets to get outside of him and pick up some yards.
That was a nicely designed play. What happened was the offensive line for the Boilermakers let the defensive linemen penetrate, and then they all peeled off and created a wall down the left side. I hadn't seen something like that before.
Holding.
That was a nice play.
Offense number 88. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Replay, second down.
Standifer called before the holding.
And that's why Standifer did such a great job of blocking. He gets called for the hold on Michael Lau. Referees throw the flag on that one, and Standifer will take it back. He got called for the hold.
Second down and 20, the ball back to the 43-yard line. Painter again in the shotgun, four wides. Painter throws quick, and a good block. Out to the 40, down the sidelines is Dorian Bryant, and Bryant finally goes out of bounds. Solomon Olamimian saved the touchdown. Oh, Purdue all of a sudden has cranked up its offense.
Mike
and
Otto.
Now Hawaii seems threatened and befuddled.
Mike Otto doing a great job again, number 65. Watch him right there at the bottom of your screen. He's going to come out and put a block on a Hawaii defender. That frees up the receiver, Bryant, to get downfield and pick up some big yards.
Dorian Bryant showing that track speed. He was a member of the Purdue team in 2004-2005, and you saw it right there.
Standifer to the near side. Orton to the far side. Bryant in the slot. First down. The throw, that's complete on the 25. And going out of bounds is Orton. So Purdue all of a sudden clicking offensively. And they are consistent. 12-yard gain. Another first down.
Purdue doing to Hawaii what we usually see Hawaii doing to everybody else. They just find the receivers in open spots here and there throughout the field. Don't narrow it down to one guy. They kind of spread it out to everybody. And just like that, the Boilermakers are on the move, trying to tie this baby up.
First down. Ball at the 22. Painter again. Double whites. Painter throws. That is complete. And that is complete to the tight end, Dustin Keller. Eliminian there, and Jacob Patek double-teamed him. But another completion, another game. Keller now two receptions for 29 yards in the game. Standifer and Bryant are flanked to the far side. Orton to the near side. Second down and five. Painter. Takes the handoff, throws over the middle. That is almost intercepted. Leonard Peters almost had his fourth interception of the season. Ball was intended for Keller, the tight end.
Boy, Solomon Elamimian got away with one for Hawaii. He practically looked like from here. He practically tackled the receiver coming across the middle. Let's see it right here. He holds him up big time, but no flag on the play. Number 41. Solomon Elamimi, you're going to see him flash by on your screen, holding on to the receiver right here.
Well, those are Pac-10 officials. You can't blame that on home cooking.
Well, John L. Smith got no case and no job.
Big play here. Third down. Long four. Whistle blows. And a timeout call by Hawaii with 13:46 left to play in the first half. Good, consistent, effective drive by Purdue.
Sears, proudly supporting UH Athletics. Call Big Island Candies or click on BigIslandCandies.com to order your favorite treats. New items are now available. Big Island Candies, home of the famous diagonally dipped shortbread cookies.
13:46 left to play in the first half. Purdue has advanced the ball all the way to the Hawaii 17-yard line.
Boy, the crowd's getting into it.
Third down and five. Painter looking right. Now throws over the middle. That is complete inside the five-yard line. Solomon Olamimian may have saved the touchdown. Dorian Bryan, who is causing all kinds of havoc in that Hawaii secondary now. 14-yard gain. Another third down conversion for Purdue, and they are turning the doorknob.
Boy, Curtis Painter, he has turned it around. Purdue's made some adjustments here. Painter started out 1 of 5 in this game. He's gone 7 of 9 since. And Purdue is just rolling it.
Bunch of flags are thrown.
Illegal substitution. Defense. Penalty will be half the distance to the goal. Still first down.
The Warriors had 12 players out there.
Boy, talk about a... There's a home field advantage.
But they got caught.
Yes, they did. Ball is down at about the 2-yard line. Jason Werner has come in at fullback. He is usually a linebacker. In motion is Standerberg. Ball is fumbled. Recovered by Hawaii. Myron Newberry.
Looked like a short pitch. He hit the fullback in the back.
Yeah, that'll stop the pitch if you hit the fullback in the back with the pitch. Boy, I tell you, it's better to be lucky than good. Hawaii dodges a big-time bullet right there at Purdue on a massive, time-consuming drive. And they shoot themselves right in the foot. A big turnaround for Hawaii.
But nice job by Myron Newberry. When the ball's on the ground, we were always taught it's about want to. Who wants to get to that ball first? And Newberry did an excellent job getting there.
So Hawaii will put the ball in play at the 9-yard line. Hawaii overloads the right side. Brennan steps up in the pocket, now throws. That is complete at the 40 to Devon Bess. Bess at the 50, gets a block. He's at the 45 of Purdue. He's at the 42 of Purdue. 49-yard pass play.
The amazing thing about that was Dan Bick had his arm outstretched, and the ball went, I don't know, a couple inches over it. Devon caught it for that game. That was a great pass. We're watching an unbelievable quarterback in Colt Brennan.
Well, you're exactly right about that. It's a game of inches. Watch him just miss it. And great concentration by Bess to keep his eye on the football and come up with a big catch for Hawaii. Needed that answer after that long Purdue drive.
First down at the 42 of Purdue. Brennan rolling. Now throws. That's complete inside the 30. With it is Grice Mullins. And Grice Mullins, 13-yard pickup. Royce Adams, David Pender there to make the stop.
The Warrior offensive line doing a good job blocking those three rushers from the Boilermaker defense. Even after quite a bit of time, Colt sensed a little pressure and stepped out to the right there to make the completion.
Brennan has all day to throw. We've mentioned that before. That offensive line is giving him nothing but time. And that time they even gave him space. First down at the 30-yard line. Brennan again throws. That's complete at the 20 to Chad Mock. And Mock to the 16.
Boy, this Purdue defense... Boy, they're on the sideline. They get a long breather. Watch their offense march down the field. And all of a sudden, on a quick change, they got to get out there. And they have just not had an answer on this drive again. In fact, this whole ball game, a drop pass by Devon Bess is what stopped Hawaii's last drive. And right now, Hawaii is just smoking.
For Mock, that's his third catch for 33 yards in the game. Mock and Sample are split to the far side. Dickerson now has come into the game. Ross Dickerson. In motion is Mock. Ball is given to Ilala with blocking. To the 10. To the 5. Touchdown!
Looks like we have a player down in the end zone. What really set that play up was both the receivers on the left side read man-to-man coverage, and they ran their defenders off towards the end zone, which just allowed Nate to have almost a clear shot. He was only contesting the last couple yards, and maybe Nate might have rolled up against Chad Mock's legs there at the end.
Yeah, he just kind of rolled over him. That's a 255-pound, 5'9 fire hydrant in Nate Ilala. He just rolled right over Chad Mock to get into the end zone.
16-yard gain.
So concern for Chad Mock. As you take a look at Nate Ilala, second touchdown of the game. Hawaii leading 13-0 over Purdue. And that follows the quick change, the fumble. Inside the 5-yard line, Hawaii takes only 4 plays to go 91 yards. Mock appears to be okay. From local to long-distance wireless to internet, Hawaiian Telcom has solutions for all of your communications needs. Hawaiian Telcom, keeping Hawaii connected. Britton Forrester is in to tack on the extra point out of the hold of Inoke Funaki. It is placed. It is kicked. And it is good. Funaki did a good job. That ball came back low. We look at the scoreboard. 11:06 left in the first half. Hawaii leading 14-0 over Purdue.
Watching K-Pop
gets you chicks.
This exclusive sports presentation of the home team is sponsored by Hawaiian Telcom. From local to long distance, wireless to internet, Hawaiian Telcom has solutions for all of your communication needs. Hawaiian Telcom, keeping Hawaii connected.
Look at Colt Brennan. That didn't take long at all for Hawaii to march up the field. Brennan is 12 of 15 for 178 yards. And we still have much time left in the first half. So you see the scoring drive, 91 yards. We mentioned that in only 4 plays, and it was lightning quick, just gobbling up real estate. Dan Kelly will kick off. Corey Sheets and Dorian Bryant are deep. This will go to Bryant, 4 yards deep in the end zone. He will not return it. This is the week of Thanksgiving, and we'd like to give our best wishes to Michael Ganatisi, who has just come back from Iraq. He is a Marine Staff Sergeant and a great football fan. Follows Hawaii all wherever he goes.
And thanks to all the troops that are out there serving around the world to protect us. A special thanks to them.
So Michael Ganatisi finally coming home.
It's a big series for the Hawaii defense. Last time out, Purdue pretty much just ran the ball right down their throats in varying degrees of effectiveness. But they got deep in Hawaii territory before a turnover stopped the drive. Let's see how Hawaii responds here.
Jason Taylor, number 33, now back. With Painter, four-man pattern. Painter throws sideline. That is complete. And hit immediately by Myron Newberry is Selwyn Lyman. 11-yard gain in the first down. Purdue goes right back to work. So the Boilermakers have advanced it to the 31-yard line.
Of course, Lyman, a big receiver, 6'4", 210. He uses every bit of that frame to struggle forward and get the first down.
Two backs in the shotgun. Ball is given up the middle to Sheets. Sheets runs into a bevy of Darth Vaders. And they treat him rather rudely. Mel Purcell leading the offensive
That split back look.
Or leading the defense, I should say.
That split back look is really meant to confuse the inside linebackers because their first key typically is they're running back to their side. And they'll cross on each other. And obviously didn't mess up the rear linebackers that time. But that's a primary design, and they can run the option off that also.
Purdue comes out with triple wide receiver to the right. Painter again hands the ball, and with it is Sheets, and we have a penalty flag. Either Sheets or Taylor. It is Taylor.
Maybe it's unnecessary reference on Adam Leonard for that tackle.
Dead ball. Personal foul. Defense number 93. Late hit with the helmet. 15-yard penalty from the end of the play on an automatic first down.
So it is a penalty against Hawaii, and it's a substantial one.
Kiala Watson, number 93, I believe is who he called it on.
And apparently it was helmet to helmet. Or maybe
a late hit. Late hit, it looked like.
Well, that's a big
job by Adam Leonard.
Big break for Purdue.
Purdue has the ball now at their own 48-yard line. They trail 14-0. The pitch on the outside goes to Taylor. And Taylor is able to push the pile. Gets it into Hawaii territory and advances it to the 45-yard line. Lafaele and Olama Francis double-teamed him there for the Warriors. Just short of the first down.
That is a lot more than you'd like to give up on first down right there for the Warrior defense. But a nice game by the Boilermakers.
Boilermakers in the Big Ten this year on the road, able to win three games. So the environment does not affect them as far as the crowd is concerned. Ball again is given on a very short game. Michael Lafaele there to make the stop.
I think Sean Sister is down. He got rolled up on from behind. He looks pretty hurt.
Dario maybe. Camacho carried that ball. That was his 12th carry.
And maybe his left leg, it looks like, the right tackle for the Boilermakers.
So Sester, we are concerned about him.
He just gets hooked up with size mismatch.
Oh, there it is.
With Michael, the fences.
Michael Lafaele rolled down the back of his leg.
So we'll take this break. Hawaii leading 14-0. So Dan Zaleski has gone in to play that offensive line. Taylor is the single setback. Under center on third and a yard is Painter. Painter tries the quarterback snake. I don't know whether he made it. Solomon Illumimian was there to plug the leak.
Well, if they use a line judge from the far side of the field, I don't think he made it.
It is going to be close. Or are they going to... It's going to be fourth down. They did not give him the first down.
Nice job there of the Warrior defensive line submarining again, which means they fire off very low down around the shins of the Boilermakers offensive line so that they can't get any movement off the ball.
I'm surprised Joe Tiller doesn't go for it here in fourth and less than a yard, but
you got to watch
the lines up for a punt at least.
J.C. Welch has come in to punt, and he angles this one straight down the middle. It goes into the end zone, and Hawaii will put the ball in play at their own 20-yard line. 43-yard punt by Welch.
But only 23 net gain.
So Hawaii will go back to work. The last time, they took a little more than 2 minutes to score on a 16-yard touchdown run by Mady Lawa. So Hawaii goes back to work again.
And Hawaii, the top offensive team in the nation in total offense, but also down on the bottom of the country as far as time of possession. This Hawaii offense, they come out, they go to work, they score lightning quick. You look at the numbers on Colt Brennan. He's mentioned on some Heisman lists, and numbers like that back it up.
Sample is in motion. First down from the 20. Brennan looking sideline, throws. That is, let's see. Now they say no. The ball hit in front of Ian Sample. That'll bring up second down and 10 from their own 20-yard line. 7:07 left to play in the first half.
Is it a catch?
Boy, that looks close. That looks close, but it was a tough call. The official was behind him and really couldn't get a good view of it.
And the way this Hawaii offense has been moving it, kind of don't want to waste the coach's challenge on that. Just line it up and play on second and 10.
Brennan and Ilala. In that shotgun. Hawaii in a tighter formation here with the four wide receivers. Brennan steps up. Throws. That is complete. At the 30 is Sample. Sample is knocked down at the 31-yard line. That is enough for a first down. Another first down for Hawaii. And David Pender made the stop.
Well, the Boilermakers have six defensive backs in the game right now, and they're still getting a lot of cushion, which shows a tremendous amount of respect for the Warrior receivers. But I think if they're going to slow them down, they're going to have to start tightening it up on their coverage.
They have six back there, and none of them are working.
Brennan, 13 of 17 for 189 yards. Brennan on first down. Hands the ball to Ilala. Ilala free in that secondary. The 40 midfield. Dragging tacklers with him all the way to the 45-yard line. Great block by Samson Satelli. 24-yard gain for Nate Ilala. And David Pender, his name has come up time and time again, was there. He may have saved a touchdown.
Well, Jim, you called it. Justin Scott, number 23, is back there to make the play. And he looks up in front of him, sees Hercules coming at him. 290 pounds with a full head of steam, and he just gets erased. In fact, Hercules took a couple of guys out of the play. Another first down for Hawaii.
First down for Hawaii at the 45-yard line. Brennan looking left, and he finally gets hit behind the line of scrimmage. And Cliff Avril got to him. Avril just kept fighting and fighting his way through. And Brennan was waiting for the deep pass to ripen. Couldn't get it away.
What a move on John Essence, number 55. Actually, Essence was out there along with Daniel Peressa. And Avril just
sort of bounced off and came around underneath.
That's right. He came on the inside move and comes up with the sack.
It will not be. I don't know whether it would be a sack because he was moving forward. It wasn't like he was not trying to advance the ball. Here's Bess. Another reception. Bess inside the 40, short of the first down. In fact, this year, Brennan has been sacked only 15 times. That's it.
That's pretty amazing when you consider how often the Warriors throw the ball. That is just unbelievable.
Now, Devon Bess has gone over 1,000 yards in receptions. Last year, he had 1,124 on 89 receptions. So he has come in here with three receptions. He has 78, and he's gone over 1,000 yards.
He's just a sophomore. If he stays here for 4 years, well, the numbers he's going to have over his career is just going to be mind-boggling.
Bess is in motion. Three wide receivers to the right. Brennan looks, and that's slapped back at him. Good play again by Cliff Avril.
That's the first time we've seen the Boilermakers in that coverage tonight. That's man free, where the free safety is back playing center field and everybody else mans up. Oftentimes they will get into that when they run a blitz, but they didn't show anything that time.
So Hawaii fails to convert on third down. That'll bring up fourth down. And for the first time in a long time, Kurt Milne comes in to punt. Milne did not punt at all in last week's game.
Maytag repairman.
Royce Adams deep for Purdue. This will take some time to come down. Adams calling for the fair catch. It takes a Purdue bounce and then is hit back toward the 20-yard line by a member of the special team. That's Papuli, Timo Paipuli. 22-yard punt. And And Purdue will have it with 4:29 left in the first half. Aloha Airlines would like to say aloha to the Warrior Seniors for all their contributions to the University of Hawaii football program and wish them success in next week's final regular season game against Oregon State and then the Hawaii Bowl against a member of the Pac-10. First down for Purdue. They come out with five wide receivers. In the shotgun by himself is Painter. Hawaii rushing only three. Painter steps up in the pocket, throws. That is caught by Orton on the 40-yard line. Boy, you rush three, and Painter is able to see the patterns ripen because he has so much time back there. He's going to start gobbling up yardage, and he did it that time, a 20-yard gain.
The Purdue receivers kind of run a crisscross, and Orton just finds a space in the seam. And Leonard Peters just a little late getting over there, and that's a big game for Purdue.
Purdue at the 40-yard line. Corey Sheets has come back in the shotgun formation with Painter. Painter looks over the middle, throws. That is bobbled, incomplete. It's intended for the tight end, Dustin Keller. Solomon Olamimian was battling him for possession. That'll bring up second down and 10 for Purdue.
Well, Jim, I think Jerry Glanville heard you about only rushing three because they brought five that time. And a nice job by Solomon on man-to-man coverage right there.
So Hawaii with a four-man front. Second down and 10 from the 40-yard line for Purdue. Painter steps up, throws. That is, let's say, incomplete. And we have a penalty flag. Michael Malama covering on the play in the secondary. We have a penalty flag there. And we also have a penalty flag in the offensive backfield. That could be holding on Purdue.
Yeah, I think this will be offsetting.
So I could. I believe you're right.
Let's do it over.
These are Pac-10 officials.
There are two fouls on the play. Holding, offense number 24. Pass interference, defense number 20. Offset, replay, second down.
4:01 left to play on the first half. Look at June Jones. Lyman is to the far side, along with Bryant. Painter fakes the handoff to Sheets. Whistle blows. So another penalty flag has been thrown.
Curtis Painter saw Mel Purcell coming
prior
at him.
Snap. Full start. Offense, number 28. 5-yard penalty, still second down.
Unblocked. And I think he saw his life pass before his eyes, but the whistle was blown.
One.
Nakoa football Thank is you. The official booster club of the University of Hawaii football team. For more information on Nakoa football, www.nakoa.org. Second down and 15. The ball now at the 35. Painter, five-man pattern. Throws, that's complete with blockers in front of him to the 40. And Dorian Bryant is wrapped up there. Just gets back to the original line of scrimmage.
Great job by Adam Leonard. He actually got down really low. And two blockers couldn't get to him, and he actually got between them and made the tackle. See it right here. It's a great job.
Where Bryant caught that ball from up here, it looked like he was going to run for days. But the Hawaii defense, they just swarmed to the football. Leonard's stuffing up the middle there, trying to get his teammates involved. It sets up a third and very long for Purdue.
Purdue, 3-4-6 in third down conversions. Third down and 10. Ball at the 41. Painter, throw sideline. That is incomplete. That was thrown behind Lyman. And that will bring up fourth down, and Purdue will have to punt it away.
Well, Newberry jumped up on top of that like he was going to go for the interception, but it was probably a good thing it was away from everybody, because that left the receiver wide open with quite a bit of space before Leonard Peters could have got to him.
There's the punt by Welch. Penalty flag again. Fair catch called at the 5-yard line by Devon Bess. 54-yard punt. And it was not Welch. It was Summers. They have been trading places back as the punter.
I think it's going to be lining up in the neutral zone in Hawaii. They were up there on the line of scrimmage.
Yep, offside. It will still be fourth down.
Yeah, Purdue should decline this, with Hawaii has got the ball down at their own six.
They could.
Of course, the last time Hawaii got the ball that deep, they took four plays and scored.
Offside defense. Penalty declined. First down.
Let's see if we can do it again. That's what June's telling his players right now.
Well, Cole Brennan, this is a chance for him to shine. Boy, the websites we've been looking at all week. I saw one website had him right behind McFadden from Arkansas on the Heisman list. And being that Arkansas just coming off a loss, kind of figured that the Cole Brennan will move up. And, boy, he has just been lining it up. 14 of 19, buck 99. His next completion yard will take him over 200. And we've got 250 left to play in the first half.
Brennan, line of scrimmage being the six. Three-man rush. Look out. Brennan is hitting the end zone. He escapes. He's out to the 10, to about the 13-yard line. Cliff Avril again almost had him for the safety.
That was Anthony Spencer, I think. Cliff Avril made the tackle. Anthony Spencer was the one that had him almost in the end zone for the safety.
There you see Avril.
That's the kind of stuff that's going to show up just as a rushing gain on the stat sheet. But this is what Cole Brennan brings to this offense, that escapability. Only 15 sacks, as you mentioned, Jim, coming in, and that's one of the reasons why.
Ball is given, and running with it is Ilawa. On second down, Ilawa, very short game that time. He does not get the first down. Bank of Hawaii recognizes excellence on the field of play. And tonight we will be selecting a member from each team as the game's most valuable player. Sponsored by Bank of Hawaii. Third down and two for Hawaii. And the Warriors tonight, 0-for-2 in third down conversions in this game. Lawa back with Brennan. Brennan, 199 passing yards. This is Ilawa. First down, 25. Ilawa to the 31. Another probing run into the Purdue secondary. This one, 16 yards. And again, credit that offensive line.
And the Purdue coaching staff was just going absolutely berserk down there on the sideline. I don't know what they're looking at. I think they saw Samson Satelli just tackle one of the Purdue defensive lineman. It's a big play by him.
Ilawa now, 8 carries, 97 yards. The pass complete to Dickerson. And Dickerson sits down at the 43-yard line. That's a 12-yard gain and a first down.
Well, I'll tell you what. I was watching Anthony Spencer go up against Tala Serra. And Tala's doing a nice job, but you can see why Anthony Spencer is so good.
So Hawaii quickly to the line of scrimmage. Under a minute to play in the first half. They would like to tack something on the board here. Brennan back to pass, four-man pattern, steps up. He's in trouble, spinning, comes to the near side. Brennan going for the sideline to run out the clock. No, he comes back to the middle, and he gets to the 33-yard line. 24-yard run by the quarterback, Brennan.
First down, stops the clock, 43 seconds is an awful long time for this Warrior offense.
Well, you almost kind of wanted to see him kind of duck out of bounds right there at the end of this play, but instead he cuts it in. That's his competitive nature, but it would have stopped the clock.
So they mark it for play. The clock starts to tick again. Brennan Ball is snapped here with 33 seconds left. The ball is given to Ilawa. He's at the 30, 25. Ilawa to the 20-yard line. And the clock narrowly ticking away. Now they stop it for the first down. A 13-yard gain.
Well, this Hawaii offense, the time almost means nothing to them. They're just moving almost like nonchalant.
That puts Nate at 110 yards rushing so far this evening.
Keith Smith finally halted his progress. 22, 21, 20 seconds left. Brennan waiting for the snap. Three wide receivers to the left. Brennan looking, steps up. Has space. Clock ticking. 7 seconds, 6 seconds. Out of bounds he goes at the 6-yard line. Good block by Devon Bess.
Well, that play ate up a lot of clock. There's probably safely only one play left.
Dan Kelly has come on. And they will try the field goal.
Well, I'm surprised by that. You saw Cole Brennan asking for one shot at the end zone. I am surprised by this to see June Jones go for a field goal here.
So timeout has been called by Purdue. That gives Coach Jones
a chance to change his mind.
Right. Yes.
I'll bet you he will, too. Colts lobbying. He's saying, hey, 6 seconds, we can get it in there and stop the clock. If they throw it into the end zone, they could potentially run a play, as long as he doesn't scramble or take a sack, run a play, and then if it's an incomplete pass in the end zone, line it up for the field goal then.
Well, if June knew he could have two plays for sure, they'd be going for it, no questions asked. I think that the golden rule is 7 seconds.
Do you think he changed his mind? Do you think he changed his mind?
I think he did.
Well, the kicker's still practicing.
Yeah, he is. But this is a kind of an opportunity for this offense.
Well, Rivers is wide open asking for the ball. We don't see the in front of him. There might have been a safety help.
Oh, yeah, there's another DB over there.
Boy, June is going for the field goal here. This surprises me. Boy, we're going to have to remove the Riverboat Gambler title from him.
I think it's a good thing. Go for what you can get. Ball is placed. It is kicked. And it is good. Hawaii now leads it 17-0 over Purdue. Hawaii will have to kick off. But what a way they moved up the field that time. As that clock was ticking away, Hawaii, almost as if they didn't pay any attention to the clock.
And running quite a bit with so little time, but every time it was a first down, that helped stop the clock.
Athletics reaches out to you each week with updates and special ticket discounts through its H-Mail newsletter. To register, just visit LAathletics.com and click on the H-Mail button. It's simple and it's free. Remember the rules this year. As soon as Dan Kelly kicks the ball, the clock starts ticking. Away, 89 yards in 8 plays, 3 minutes and 3 seconds of elapsed time, 22-yard field goal by Dan Kelly. Kelly in field goals now 9 for 10, his longest 42 yards, and that was way back in the opener of this season against Alabama.
And the key for him is to keep this kick in bounds.
He squibs it. And they fall on it at the 28-yard line. The clock expires at the end of the first half. Hawaii shutting out Purdue 17-0. This game summary is sponsored by Burger King. Have it your way. Chris Painter, 133 yards in passing in the first half. No touchdowns. And Colt Brennan, 211 yards of passing in the first half. Also, no touchdowns. There you see the first downs. Hawaii with the advantage there. Rushing yards. Hawaii with the advantage there, especially with the running of Nate Ilawa. And then the passing yards, we mentioned that. And then the total offense. Hawaii already at 365 yards. It was that key turnover, too, that really started to turn the game into Hawaii's favor. Purdue started to come back, but they fumbled inside the five-yard line. Hawaii turned that fumble into a score. Now you see the third down conversions.
You know, everybody always talks about the Warrior offense, but let's take a look at the Warrior defense, what they're contributing to this game. Here we have a nice stop by the Michael Afaeli right there on the line of scrimmage. Coming back with another run. And a nice stop right there by Mel Purcell. They're going to show some pressure on the quarterback. Just missed getting to him. Of course, a nice recovery by Newberry after the Painter pitched it off the fullback's back.
And Hawaii got a gift turnover right there, and it didn't take them long to score. They go right back to work using every weapon in the arsenal. First, Devon Best, deep middle, breaks a couple of tackles. He'll set Hawaii up at midfield. Then the next pass play, Cole Brennan has to scramble to buy some time. He's going to hit Ryan Dreis-Mullins. Dreis-Mullins gets a big gainer. That's the second play of that drive. They come right back, go the other way. Chad Mock, he's going to take it into the red zone for Hawaii. Then it's Nasty Nate. Four plays, the length of the field, Hawaii leaving Purdue reeling at that point as Nadegawa takes it in. As Jim said, the turning point for this Warrior team.
For What's on Tap, sponsored by Heineken, I turn to Mr. Donovan and Mr. Yamanoha to find out what to look for in the second half.
Well, are we going to see a passing TD for Colt? This is actually the second game of the year that Colt has not had a passing TD in the half. The other time was the first half at Alabama. I'd like to see Colt have them put some new numbers over there on that far side of the stadium and move it up towards 52.
The touchdown tally for Hawaii. Pressure the Boilers. Get out there and get after it. It's the conference season is over, and everybody's watching to see how you do against a Big Ten team, especially one with a winning record in Purdue. Just put the pressure on them. Go at it. I think that's what we'll see out of this Hawaii team here in the second half.
When we come back, we'll have the opening kickoff of the second half, and Hawaii will put the ball in play.
Hawaii businesses know recruiting and retaining employees is a crucial element in
another reason why Kate. This exclusive sports presentation of the Home Team is sponsored in part by American Savings Bank, helping Hawaii's businesses and communities grow, and by Kaiser Permanente. Thrive.
Tonight's halftime adjustment is sponsored by Cairo Plan Hawaii.
The first adjustment this evening is tighten up the coverage. I believe the Purdue Boilermakers, who are running with 5 and 6 DBs on most plays, are going to have to tighten up their coverage if they want to slow down the Warrior offense. And they might want to even consider making one of them a robber back. And his sole job would be to try and go after the pick, because this thing could get away from them.
And for Hawaii, we talked about it in the open, and we're talking about it now. They've got to get out there and just seize the moment. The WAC season is over. They can't do nothing about that. Boise State has won the WAC. So now for them is to come out and just make some noise on a national level and against a team like Purdue. 17 points in the first half is good, but we got a lot of football left to play.
This is a moment of pride for this Hawaii team. I mean, they struggle. They're 2,500 miles away from the nearest Division I competition. And they are kind of the addendum to the great land. And they don't get a lot of space nationally. But for the first time since 1993, they have been nationally ranked in the Associated Press poll. And they want to stay there. They have taken a step in this game. They lead 17 to nothing over Purdue. But Purdue has been able to move the ball. Purdue's job, of course, is to stop this vaunted Hawaii offense. Hawaii will get the first crack offensively. Malcolm Lane and Ross Dickerson are deep. Kicking off is Chris Summers for Purdue as we start the second half. Hawaii up 17-0. Short kick. Ball is taken by Malcolm Lane to the 30, to the 31-yard line. And Hawaii had very good field position to start this second half. Colt Brennan, 15 of 20, 211 yards, his longest pass, 49 yards. Men's basketball, Hawaii over Pacific, 71-60 in the great Alaska shootout.
Probably a good thing right there to kick it away from Ross Dickerson, who leads the WAC and is ninth in the NCAA in kickoff return, averaging 28.8 yards. That was the first one this evening for the Warriors.
So Hawaii begins. They punch the clock with the ball at the 31. Colt Brennan looking over a four-man front. Brennan, swing pass, almost intercepted. It is intercepted, and that will be a touchdown for Purdue. Cliff Avril, who has been giving Hawaii fits all night defensively, just reaches up and takes that pass and runs it in 31 yards for the touchdown.
Well, they're talking about something, Jim. I'm wondering if it didn't hit the ground or something. Maybe they're considering it a lateral.
Yeah, it's going to come down to if the ball went forward. It looks like from that angle that it might may have gone backwards.
And it did touch the ground. The officials let it go. They didn't call it right away. That gave Avril a chance to sprint for the end zone.
It depends on whether or not it's a lateral.
That was
on the field is a forward pass.
That's correct.
Incomplete.
It was totally, you could see, it was an overhand throw, and the defensive lineman knocked the ball down to the ground, and it bounced up, and he ran with it. That's a very good call.
Boy, that was just the way this
see,
was
right
instant.
Right there. It hits his hand, goes down, bounces off the ground. That's an incomplete pass.
Right, but if he's throwing it backwards or equal to the line of scrimmage, it's a fumble. It would be a lateral.
Joe Tiller not happy with the call, but he can't say that these are Western Athletic Conference officials. These are Pacific 10 officials, Pac-10. And that's a BCS conference, Mr. Tiller. Second down and 10, the ball at the 31-yard line. Run and throw, sideline pattern. That is complete to Jason Rivers. So Rivers with his third reception. That'll bring up third down for Hawaii. Third and three. Ball at the 38-yard line. Bess and Sample are to the far side. Mock is to the near side. See if Hawaii can convert on third down here. Brennan throws. That is complete to Mock. First down at the 49-yard line of Purdue. Another completion, another first down. George Hall, the linebacker, and David Pender again, the corner. He's been busy. Yeah. They were on the defense.
That's a shot. And Mock, give him credit, makes the catch. He just pops right back up on his feet.
Here comes Hawaii first down. They give him forward progress. Boy, only to midfield. They come out in four wides. Again, the four-man front. Now a 4-4 defense as they move a corner up. Brennan steps up, lays it off. This is Ilawa. Ilawa fumbles the ball. It is picked up by Purdue, and Hawaii will have a turnover. Anthony Spencer.
Boy, Hawaii dodged a bullet on that earlier play, and they shoot themselves right in the foot here as Nate Ilawa. Let's see if he fumbles it here. Oh, yeah, it's
that,
out.
That came out after the hit by Spencer was picked up by Al Royal. So Purdue trying to take advantage of a Hawaii turnover here. Hawaii, here in the second half, cannot take their foot off the pedal. They can't half-step their way against a team that can throw the way Purdue can. First down for the Boilermakers at the 49-yard line of Hawaii. Curtis Painter takes the handoff. Back to pass. With time. Throws. That is complete. And that ball was just zipped in there. Michael Malala was on the tackle. Desmond Tardy, number 6, was not tardy at all. He showed up at the exact right time.
Nice job of pass protection right there by the Boilermaker offensive line.
So here comes Purdue. They have not been able to score in this game, but they have an opportunity here on the Hawaii turnover. Two running backs behind Painter. He gives the ball to Sheets, and Corey Sheets angles off the right side, trying for the first down. He is a yard short. Michael Lafayette, number 67. You see him getting up there. Lafayette there with yet another tackle.
And Mel Purcell is the guy who's on the spotlight right here. Sean Sesser, the right tackle for Purdue, went down with a knee injury in the first half. Garrett Miller, a junior, is his backup. He's playing right tackle, number 51. And he's working off Mel Purcell. Mel Purcell, the reigning WAC Defensive Player of the Week. It's a good matchup. See how he can respond to it.
Purdue comes out again in the shotgun. Double running back. They're going to throw. Painter does throw. That is complete to the tight end, Kyle Adams. And Adams gets to the 30-yard line. And that's a first down for the Boilermakers. Adam Leonard made the tackle for Hawaii. Rather, excuse me, that's Jake Standiford. Standiford, number 88. Adams was number 85.
Well, Hawaii comes in. Everybody's trying to strip that ball out of there. Standiford just holds on to that thing and keeps the legs moving. Picks up some yards for Purdue.
Triple wide receiver to the right. First down for Purdue. Ball is given on a sweep. With it is Dorian Bryant. And Bryant able to gain from the 30 inside the 25-yard line. Myron Newberry there to make the stop for Hawaii. So Purdue keeping the ball, moving the ball. And they are just outside the red zone at the 24-yard line. It will be second down and five.
Does a nice job of Dorian getting downhill quickly and picking up, looks like it'll be 5 yards. And this march is keeping the Hawaii offense off the field.
Tight end sets up. Now double tight end. Painter looking. Throws for the end zone. Incomplete. That was intended for Dustin Keller, the tight end. And Myron Newberry covering on the play for Hawaii. That'll bring up third down. Hawaii has, on running plays, been very effective defensively so far in the game. Third down conversions, you see Purdue 4 for 8. Orton is flanked to the far side. And Lyman to the near side. Inside Lyman, Bryant. And also Standiford. Painter, quick pass. That is complete to Sheets. Out of the backfield, he not only has the first down, he advances the ball to the 10. Newberry finally made the tackle for Hawaii. 13-yard gain for Purdue.
It's a mismatch for Hawaii. Is he Kai Kalama? Francis goes out in coverage. He's a lineman. He's going to come out, try to run with Sheets. And Sheets just runs right away from him. As a defensive end goes out in pass coverage on that zone look for Hawaii.
They put the ball at the 11. High formation. Under center is Painter to Sheets. Sheets gets bottled up immediately. Solomon Illumimian hit him, the linebacker. Sheets with a gain just inside the 10-yard line. That will bring up second down. And goal to go. The last time that Purdue was down here, they fumbled inside the 5-yard line. Hawaii was able to turn that around and score a touchdown. And do it in a hurry. Lyman and Orton are the wide receivers. In the slot is Bryant. Painter with time. Throws to the end zone. Touchdown. Dustin Keller. Dustin Keller, the tight end. That's his third touchdown reception of the year. And for Painter, that is his 18th touchdown pass. And Keller just simply drifted behind the defense. 9-yard touchdown pass. And it is now 17-6.
Watch him. He puts an outside move on Mike Aloud. Then he curls back to the middle, right behind the linebacker. I think it's Adam Leonard. And he uses every bit of his size to make the touchdown catch right there, 6'4", 244.
Extra point is put up by Summers. It's now 17-7 in favor of Hawaii. When we come back, the Warriors on their home field will try to answer back. Purdue, 49 yards in 8 plays. Following a Nate Ilawa fumble, 3 minutes 47 seconds of elapsed time. Painter to Keller, 9-yard touchdown pass. It's 17-7. Both teams now have used a turnover by the other to score points.
You know, all year long, Jim, the tight end position has caused some difficulty for the Warrior defense. And I thought it might happen again tonight, especially since he was a converted wide receiver.
Kicking off is Summers. Kicks it deep into the end zone. Dickerson lets it go. It goes out of the end zone, and Hawaii will begin at the 20-yard line. From local to long distance, wireless to internet, Hawaiian Telcom has solutions for all your communications needs. Hawaiian Telcom, keeping Hawaii connected. Well, 9:20 left to play in the third, and this game all of a sudden has become interesting as far as scoring is concerned. Hawaii came out. They dodged one bullet on a lateral and a pass that was incomplete, but not the fumble. So Purdue rededicating themselves here in the second half. Hawaii must answer back. First down from the 20. In the shotgun, four-man front for Purdue. Brennan looking, throws as he's hit. That is almost picked off, almost intercepted. And now Purdue is starting to really put the pressure on. Lion Bryce Mullins was the intended receiver. Covering on the play was Justin Scott, and he almost picked it off. Brennan in the first half just had all kinds of time. But here you can see Anthony Spencer putting the pressure on. Spencer with 10.5 sacks on the season. Second down and 10 from the 20.
The Boilermakers are in their base defense, the 4-3.
Hawaii comes out with triple wide receiver to the right side. Brennan looking left. Brennan looking now, throws long over the middle. That is intercepted. Intercepted by Justin Scott. He almost picked off one before, and this time he was right there. The ball was intended for Ian Sample. That time Brennan got greedy, tried to force it in. He's chased out of the pocket here. Sets up, looks long, throws, and right there coming over was Justin Scott. That's Scott's second interception of the season and the ninth Brennan interception. So now Hawaii knows that Purdue has the momentum.
Gut check time for this Hawaii defense.
Sweep to the near side to Taylor. And Taylor gets from the line of scrimmage, the 48, down close to the 40-yard line, and a penalty flag, and we'll see if it's on Hawaii. Could be on Gerard Lewis. Lewis came over, did something late. Did something outside the rules. Personal foul.
Dead ball. Personal foul. Defense, number 23.
I guess that extra did a
15-yard penalty from the end of the play.
Physicality was called there. Now the ball comes back. And Purdue has advanced it because of the penalty to the 25-yard line. This is not good. Hawaii led 17-0 at halftime. And now Purdue chipping away. It's 17-7, and they definitely have the momentum. Orton is to the far side. Kyle Adams is the wing to the near side. Here's the pitch. With it is Cardi. He's going to throw. That is, let's see what the call is. Referees are talking.
I think they're trying to discuss whether or not he was knocked out of bounds. They're calling it a touchdown.
Touchdown for Kyle Adams.
The old pitch and pass.
Adams has both feet down, yes. That was a good call. So all of a sudden, Purdue has come out, and it has not taken them long to reclaim the Big Ten reputation.
The ball actually bounced off his chest and back into his hands. It was a nice job of concentration.
So Summers will come in to tack on the extra point. That would make it 17-14. And a brand new game. A brand new game. Ball is put down. It is kicked And it is perfect. 17 for Hawaii, 14 for Purdue. And this crowd is stunned, literally stunned.
Need help staffing your business? Listen to what some of Hawaii's top employers say about Midweek and the Star Bulletin's Star Classifieds.
We're currently expanding, and Star Classified has helped us tremendously with our recruiting efforts. Not only did they bring a quantity of
magically delicious.
Wow, this game has turned around. Kyle Adams. Battling Gerard Lewis, you just see Peters come over. And he's able to take the hit from Peters and hold on. You see the ball bounce, but he did get his feet in. 17 for Hawaii, 14 for Purdue. And Purdue has come back in a hurry. There's the kick by Summers. It is taken by Ross Dickerson on the 3-yard line. Dickerson breaks one tackle, but then the Whiteshirts converge on him at the 20.
Well, in the last play, we saw Colt Brennan out here. He threw into triple coverage, and I think most of the year we've seen it happen, and he's gotten away with it, but maybe it's the Big Ten athletes in the secondary that just didn't allow him to get away with it one more time.
Well, it is a moment that Hawaii must ponder here. National ranking, they are just holding on, 17-14, but this offense has had that kind of potential all year, that even though they are threatened, they have been able to answer back from the shotgun. Triple wide receiver to the right. Brennan with Ilawa back there with him. Brennan throws. That is complete to Ilawa on the screen. To the 30. Out to the 34-yard line. Yard pickup and a first down for Nate Ilawa. Hawaii goes back to work. 7:50 left to play in the third period.
Colt Brennan has to take one for the team right there. The lineman let the defensive line come across and he just floats it over to Colt Brennan. Watch the end of this play as he takes a shot. Well, not really a shot. He just kind of goes down. Nice job of Purdue not getting a penalty there.
In motion is Bess. Now they have trips allowed to the left. Again, it is Ilawa. Ilawa breaks one tackle, able to spin into the secondary, holds on to the ball, gets over the 35, the line of scrimmage being the 34, and we'll see where they put it. George Hall, leading tackler for Purdue, there to make the stop. Hall, the middle linebacker. This has turned into a shootout now. Hawaii trying to answer back. Second down. Gain on the play of 3. Second and 7. There's the shovel pass. With space is Ilawa. Midfield, and they trip him up there. What a call. When Ilawa got that shovel pass as he scampered for 14 yards. Oh, they were great possibilities on that because he was in space. Royce Adams finally figured things out.
And he's been featured on this drive, and why not? He had the fumble on the previous drive, but he's a senior, and you know he wants the ball back to atone for that turnover, and so far, Nate Ilawa is doing a great job of that.
Reagan Mau'ia now has come in to the backfield with Brennan.
Longer stretch for Colt without a TD.
Brennan back to pass, throw sideline pattern. That is complete to Mock. Slips, but gets inside the 40-yard line. Another first down for Hawaii.
We've seen this all year long. When a team goes to a four-down lineman front, June responds and adjusts very quickly with the short passes. He runs the wide receiver screen. We may see that. He also runs a shovel pass, and he'll run the Tampa right and left. And those are very effective against four down linemen fronts.
12-yard gain on that last play. Another first down for Hawaii. Mock, along with Bess and Dickerson to the far side. Rivers to the near side. First down from the Purdue 37. With it is Malia. Malia carrying tacklers with him. Able to get to the 35-yard line. George Hall went for a ride, but is credited with the tackle.
The reason why those plays are so effective is because if the ball carrier can get on the other side of the four down linemen, they often have a free shot deep into the secondary.
Hawaii putting together a consistent drive here. 5:23 left to play here in the third quarter.
Purdue's adjusted to a three down lineman front.
In motion is Rivers. Stepping up, Brennan throws sideline, and that throw too high. It was intended for Ross Dickerson. And Dickerson was covered by Aaron Lane that time for Purdue. Dangerous pass.
Tell you what, you can see why Anthony Spencer is so good. That young man has a motor on him that just doesn't quit. He was actually triple-teamed by the Warriors and still almost got to the back of Colt when he was throwing the ball. He is an exceptional defensive end.
Third down, long yardage for Hawaii. 3rd and 9. The ball is just outside the 35-yard line of Purdue. Big play here. Brennan, triple wide receiver to the right. Looks long. Looks long. Now throws. And it's batted away. Cliff Avril again. So Hawaii faces a fourth down.
Boy, Colt Brennan, he's going to take a shot to the face right here. Incomplete pass. He's lucky it wasn't hit to somewhere that was a Purdue defender, but he had some wide open space in front of him, but tried to get rid of it. Sets up a fourth down for Hawaii. If you take another look at it, Brennan takes a shot from Avril and gets up kind of shaking that throwing hand. See if he got tweaked there on the play.
Milne is in to punt for Hawaii on fourth down from the 35-yard line.
We're going to take a look at the previous play, see if it was an incomplete pass or a fumble, I guess.
Was it picked up by a Purdue player, or did it roll out of bounds?
I believe it rolled out of bounds. But then you'd mark the ball where it left the offensive player's hand versus back to the original line of scrimmage.
4:54 left to play in the third period. See Brennan and Avril getting to him. Purdue was unable to get to him, especially in the first half. But here in the second half, all kinds of pressure and problems.
Oh, boy. And it was a good thing for Purdue that Avril got there, because Hawaii had a defender crossing over the end zone. Yeah, he was wide open. I'm pretty sure Colt was headed out that way. But, boy, we have not seen things come apart for this Hawaii team this year at all like this.
The ruling on the field is confirmed. Incomplete pass. Fourth down.
So instead of the fumble, it is fourth down. And Hawaii has got to give the ball back to Purdue. And Hawaii, here in the second half, here in the third quarter, has not been able to stop the Boilermakers. Dan Kelly now has come on.
Wow.
And Kelly will try a gargantuan field goal, 52 yards. His longest of the year, 42. He is capable. He is capable.
Well, June has been surprising us with field goals in this game, huh?
It's placed. It's kicked. It has the distance. It's good. A 2-yard field goal by Dan Kelly.
Dan Kelly from 52, 53 yards. Has to get a low trajectory on it. He does that and watch the reaction. He knows it's good. Alama Francis says, hey, nice slap on the head there. That's how you do it, a kicker right there. So Hawaii, 63 of 70 on point after kicks. But 53-yard field goals, not a problem.
That Akaiko's, I love you, man. Great kick.
That just makes a kicker feel like he's part of the action.
Dorian Bryant and Corey Sheets deep for Purdue. Kelly kicking off. Hawaii now leading 20-14. It will be returned by Bryant. Bryant! and is tripped up before he gets to the 15-yard line. Dighton Caldera. Caldera on the special teams got him.
Really nice job of breaking down right there, getting his feet underneath him. That's one of the things you always teach the defenders going down on the kickoff coverage is don't go down out of control. Get down there quick, get under control, make the tackle. Great job by Guyton.
Now the Hawaii defense has to step up. Now Purdue's been moving it. Two touchdowns here in the third quarter, and they're only up six. It's Hawaii.
Painter from the shotgun. Gives the ball. Big hole into the secondary over the 20. All the way out to the 25-yard line is Jason Taylor. Taylor from Hawthorne, California, and a transfer to Purdue.
Solomon
from LA, from LA Harbor Junior College.
Solomon Elamimian popping right there into the gap, getting blocked, and it helps create an even larger hole. You can see Mel, getting double teamed.
And Mel Purcell got erased by a couple of 300 pounders.
First down for Purdue. Sweep to the near side. Again, it's Taylor. And Taylor goes from the line of scrimmage, the 25, up to the 30. Michael Lafayette, again trailing the play, makes the tackle. So Purdue using up the clock, but at the same time gaining yardage and starting to put together another consistent drive. 3:47 left in the third period.
That's like the third time that they've ran that sweep on first down. It's been very effective for them getting to second and short. In this case, second and five, which is still pretty good for a second down.
And they're running to the right behind that backup tackle again. We'll talk about it. Garrett Miller coming in for the injured Sean Sester.
Taylor back there with Painter in the shotgun. Painter to throw with time. Looks sideline. Now throws long. That is it caught? No. They say the tight end, Dustin Keller, who was by himself, did not have possession when he went out of bounds.
Well, that was a really nice throw by Curtis Painter and a really nice effort by Dustin Keller to catch it, even if it was out of bounds by the time he had control.
That'll bring up third down, another third down conversion here attempt for Purdue. They are 5-for-9 in third down conversions. Orton and also Bryant to the far side. Again, from the shotgun. Painter throws. That is complete. That's enough for a first down. And it goes to Standiford from Monrovia, Indiana. 6'2 senior, the wide receiver. And another first down for Purdue. Purdue trailing by six. At halftime, they trail by 17. And there's 3 minutes and 8 seconds left to play here in the third period. Well, it's given, this is Taylor. Taylor with running room to midfield all the way to the 49-yard line of Hawaii. 14-yard gain for Purdue. Boy, Purdue has come out in this second half. And they have made Hawaii befuddled.
That's actually a counterplay that's been around for years, but the Boilermakers ran it very effectively right there. It actually gets the whole defense to react away from where the ball's actually going to end up.
Leonard Peters came over to make the tackle. The ball is placed at the 48-yard line. Purdue has never led in this game, but they have a chance here with a touchdown and a point after to take the lead. 2:49 left to play in the third. And the crowd here, biggest crowd of the year, sits a little bit more toward the front of their seats. Triple wide receiver now to the right. Painter with all kinds of time. Throws. That is incomplete. Threw in the double coverage as it was intended for Standiford. Jacob Patek credited with getting there, along with Elamimian and Gerard Lewis. Look at Joe Tiller. Joe Tiller for a coach who didn't want to play this game. And probably at the start of the game still didn't want to play it. And the way things went in the first half, he said, boy, I'm telling you. But he said something at halftime that has really put the energy in his team. Second down and 10. Ball is given to Sheets. And Sheets gets back to the line of scrimmage, and that's all. Mel Purcell was able to close him down. That'll bring up third down and 10. So a big third down play here for Purdue. Purdue with just an opportunity to seize this game.
That's just Big Ten beef right here, running the Hawaii defensive line to the outside, but Hawaii is doing a great job of standing their ground, getting some penetration, and stopping the run.
Clay Suarez also in on that last play. Third down and 10. Painter to throw. With time, throws. That's caught by Bryant. He is short of the first down. Leonard Peters made the tackle.
Oh, the crowd's
going to react. They gave him. That's a terrible spot as far as Hawaii is concerned. He was definitely short of the first down. Definitely short.
On that last play, the Warriors bring two linebackers, and nobody can get to the quarterback. In fact, Painter has quite a bit of time. He's able to make this nice completion. See where the mark is. Seems fairly generous from that replay.
Wow.
I think they gave him a yard.
That's Pac-10 officials helping out the Big Ten right there.
That was a very generous spot. If that's where the spot is, this is a first down. Crowd will not like this at all. Let's see. Nope, first down.
Well, Hawaii's not been tested like this at home all season long. The games at home have all been blowouts. Now they're trying to hang on and nurse this six-point lead. But the tests don't get any bigger for this Hawaii defense right here. Two turnovers in the second half with the Hawaii offense. Now the defense needs to step up and make some plays.
Pitch to the near side. This is Taylor. Whistle blows. And I believe we're going to have a coach's challenge. Let's see, because of the way that June Jones was reacting.
False start.
Offense,
number 51.
I just wonder whether Coach Jones tried to issue a coach's challenge across the way, because he was really animated running up on the sidelines, talking to one of the officials. I guess that's all by the board. It is still first down, first and 15. Ball is given. No, it's Dustin Taylor. Taylor is stopped by Solomon Illuminian. So another good fake by the quarterback that time.
Jacob Patek's coming out of blitz, and Painter turns around, and Patek's standing right in there, but he gets the ball away, and it's a big game for Purdue.
It's on the 37-yard line of Hawaii. Orton to the far side. Standiford to the near side. Tight end. Kellers sets up on the right. Painter. Four-man pattern. Painter chased out of the pocket by Kafensis. And Kafensis trips him up. Painter maintains his balance, gets to the 35-yard line. That'll bring up third down.
We've really got to credit that Boilermaker offensive line. They've been doing a very good job. Hawaii's bringing five guys, six guys sometimes, and they're able to hold them off.
That's the last defensive. If he doesn't get that, Painter's still running.
That's the last play of the third quarter. The fourth quarter looms. Hawaii just holding on, 20-14. And again, Purdue pressuring.
The outside.
The UH Athletic Scholar Spotlight for this week is on Kelly Sproat of the women's swimming and diving team. The Scholar Spotlight is presented by AIG Hawaii. Discover the AIG advantage. Now it's the fourth quarter. It all comes down to the next 15 minutes. There you see the total offense. 429 for Hawaii, 304 for Purdue. But Purdue has been able to move the ball with almost reckless abandon in this second half. And another big third down conversion faces them here. But they have been 7 for 11 in third down conversion. They come out with five wide receivers. Five. Empty backfield. Painter throws. That is complete inside the 30-yard line, and that should be enough for a first down. They convert again. This time it's Jason Taylor out of the back or out of where he was on the line of scrimmage. One of those five receivers.
Well, if I didn't know better on that last play, you'd think you were watching a June Jones offense. You know, using third or fourth down and just doing that nice five-yard out, getting the first down.
This Hawaii defensive line needs to make the play right here. Mel Purcell and Kaikalama Francis.
With it is Painter. Painter throws for the end zone all by himself. And is that a touchdown? That is. That is a touchdown for Orton, Greg Orton.
That was an old-fashioned bootleg to the right.
I mean,
Curtis Painter.
He was by himself. He went right by the Hawaii secondary. And we're tied at 20. And he just got in. Just got his toes inside the line, according to that angle. Now, for the first time, Purdue can take the lead. Summers out of the hold of Painter. It's kicked. And it is good. Purdue has come back with a tremendous performance here in this second half. And they lead for the first time in the game 21-20.
How lucky can one guy be? I kissed her.
Burger. She kissed me. Fries, and a 24-year-old bottle of French Bordeaux. The Carl's Jr. $6,000 combo meal, exclusively at the Palms.
Call Big Island Candies or click on BigIslandCandies.com to order your favorite treats. New items are now available. Big Island Candies, home of the famous diagonally dipped shortbread cookies.
Nice. We're going to watch a replay here again of Greg Orton doing a very nice job of concentrating and making sure both of those feet get inbounds. There's one, drags the other one. Just a really nice job of concentration. And the touchdown.
When's the last time we've seen Hawaii play from behind on this yard?
Short kick. Lands at the 15. And is taken at the 10. And down goes Ross Dickerson. And he's just in a mix master. Boy, Purdue, you can tell Purdue is sky high right now. They have come from a 17-0 deficit at halftime. And they have scored 21 points. Here in the second half, Hawaii has scored only three, a 52-yard field goal by Dan Kelly. That's been it. Hawaii starts deep in their own territory. And now the crowd is beginning to sense some uncertainty in the confidence of Hawaii. They've got to regain it. Purdue, 86 yards in 12 plays, 5 minutes of elapsed time, 28-yard touchdown pass, Painter to Orton, 21-20, Purdue. So Hawaii's got to come back. Four-man front. And that ball slapped away again from Brennan. Tried to get it to Ilawa. Anthony Spencer.
Boy, Colt Brennan. This is one of those career moments right here. The time is now for him to step up and lead this team. Curtis Painter has come in here and equaled Brennan. Brennan's 21 of 32. Painter's 20 of 31. So those two guys have gone back and forth. And right now, Colt Brennan, boy, with that interception, couple of balls batted down, boy, he needs to step it up right here and get it done, and get it done now.
Painter has two TDs, though.
This four-man front, something else. Brennan shovels it. This is Ilawa to the 20, to the 23-yard line, and that's enough for a first down. 12-yard gain, and that was all Nate Ilawa. He was carrying defenders with him.
Colt Brennan going down in the sack. Just kind of shot, puts it out there, and then you're right, Jim. It's all Nate Ilawa after that. Watch him almost get the knee down, but he gets it out of there clean. And Nady Lawa does a good job of working for that extra yards, getting the first down.
Nice heads-up play by Colt.
Again, the four-man front. Hawaii receivers having trouble getting free. Brennan steps up, looks, nobody open. He'll run. He's at the 30 and dives for the first down. He's very close. 11-yard gain. That should be enough for the first down, and it is.
Well, Ryan Baker there going one-on-one with John Estes, just battling it out. You know, you might have thought John might have held him, but nothing was called. Just a lot of battling going down there between the offense and defensive lines.
So, Mauia is in the game on the wing. And there's only three wide receivers. Away, he's trying to adjust. Here's Ilawa, probing the secondary, getting into the secondary, to the 50, to the 40, again carrying people with him, to the 30, to the 26-yard line. Terrell Vincent finally halted him, a 38-yard gain by Ilawa.
That puts Ilawa up to 151 yards tonight.
Well, you're watching him at the end of the play, and you're just going, hang on to that ball, baby. And he does. He's dragging that Boilermaker defense right along with him. Take a look at it again. Alawa's got the ball in his right hand. They come in to try to strip it out of there. And he puts that other hand on there, and he just barrels his way for about another 10.
And that's how much he's matured this season, putting both arms on the ball like that. Great job by Nate.
Hawaii back to four wide receivers again. Brennan throws. And that is a diving catch by Ian Sample inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. Oh, Hawaii need to score. They need to score a touchdown. Dan Dick made the tackle for Purdue. Hawaii moving the ball again. Brennan, 291 yards in passing, 23 for 34. But no touchdowns in this game, none. And Painter, 232 yards. He is 20 for 31. He has two touchdowns. Second down and one for Hawaii. Brennan looking, throws. That's complete. Outside the 15-yard line, but enough for the first down to Devon Bess. Now the yards get tough. Now the yards get tough. Because the defense doesn't have to cover deep. 11:53 left to play in the game. 21-20 Purdue. Sample wide to the near side. And Mock wide to the left. Brennan throws. That is complete. To Ross Dickerson, leaping for the end zone. Touchdown! Touchdown pass, and what a performance by Dickerson as he went airborne at the 3-yard line.
Well, the Boilermakers were in a man zone mixed coverage, and Royce Adams missed the tackle right there and allowed Ross to make a great leap into the air for a touchdown.
That's Hawaii taking advantage of a freshman cornerback right there, and Hawaii, boy, they needed to respond, and did they ever. Let's see if they can keep the momentum rolling.
Forrester has come in for the point after. It is good. 11:20 left to play in the game. 26 for Hawaii. 21 for Purdue. 49. Touchdown of the year for Brennan. 49th.
This is a landmark
game is sponsored by Aloha Airlines, a proud supporter of UH Sports. For reservations and fare specials, visit AlohaAirlines.com. Hawaii, 309 yards in passing, and Purdue, 257, according officially. We have Colt Brennan 10 yards away from setting the single season mark, currently held by Tim Chang. Kicking off is Kelly. into the corner of the end zone. It is caught there, and then stepping out of bounds is Bryant. So Purdue will put the ball in play at the 20.
Is Dickerson working out?
Nice job there. What it was a cross to sort of pull the defenders off in that partial zone. A missed tackle on the man-to-man coverage. Touchdown, Ross Dickerson.
When you saw that earlier shot, that ISO of a Colt Brennan sitting on the bench, the camera shaking up in the upper deck at Aloha Stadium. This crowd is getting into it big time. They know what's riding on this game for the Warrior football team, ranked 25th in the country.
Here comes Purdue, and this looks exactly like the Hawaii offense. Exactly. Four wide. Ball is given up the middle, and going from the 20 to about the 25-yard line is Corey Sheets, tackled by Blaise Suarez, number 53. And so the clock will become an ever-important factor. Timmy Chang, 4,474 yards, single-season passing record. That was in 2002. Brennan came into this game with 4,155. He needs 10. Second down and 5. Painter, pump fake, throws to Bryant, and Bryant is hit at the line of scrimmage. Maybe he got a yard. Alama Francis was there to halt his progress.
Plus, the Hawaii defenders do a good job of working off blocks, and they come up and stuff that screen pass. The Alama Francis coming off the right defensive end spot to make the play. This Hawaii defense needs to step up right here on 3rd and 5.
Big third down play. Huge. Painter with time. Throws. That is complete, and that is a first down to Lyman. So the drive continues. Lyman catching that ball in front of Michael Malala. Malala getting there just too late. Another first down, and another third down conversion for Purdue.
The Warriors in nickel coverage. Painter just has quite a bit of time, and when you give him that much time, he can easily pick up 6 or 7 yards, which he did right there.
Here comes Purdue, the Big Ten. Orton. Minutes ago, a touchdown pass. He is flanked to the right side. Lyman to the left. Painter hands the ball up the middle. This, carrying it is Sheets, struggles into the secondary, breaking tackles, and gets out to about the 38-yard line. Michael Lafaele there made another tackle for Hawaii. Lafaele has really played his heart out.
That was a great running effort by Corey Sheets. I mean, he just kept his legs going. There was people flying all around him, into him, over him, under him. And he just grinded it out for a 6-yard gain.
Second down. Second down about 4.5. The ball just short of the 39-yard line. Painter. Throws. That is complete. Patek there grabbing Dustin Keller, the tight end. When in doubt, Purdue has gone to the tight end. And they have gone to the tight end for huge dividends over the course of this game. That's enough for the first down.
This is almost like watching the Hawaii offense. And no tight end in the Hawaii offense, but it's just they'll take what the defense gives them. People just run out 5, 6, 7 yards on the field, settle in the zone, find the seam. Painter hits them for little gains here and there. And so far, he's 23 of 34 for 245.
Painter again. Then that shotgun. Tight end sets up on the right side. Painter, tight end in the pattern. Painter throws. That is complete. And with it is Sheets. And he can run. He's to the 40. He's to the 30. And out of bounds at the 20-yard line. It appeared to be a clip, but no call on that play. 36-yard pickup.
Four missed tackles by the Warriors on that play. Two by linebackers. Two more as the play continued on for that long game.
Let's see if you can see what Jim was talking about in the clip. It looks like here on the edge.
Good stiff arm. There.
Yeah, right there on Jacob Patek. A clear block in the back. No call on that one.
So the ball inside the 20 to the 19-yard line. And you get Sheets. If they're able to get that ball past Patek. You get Sheets in the open field. He can do some damage. 8:19 left. This again is Sheets. And Sheets gets swallowed up in the middle.
Very good job of the Warrior defense stringing that out. That's the play that Purdue's been running on first down and getting 5 or 6 yards a crack. Nice job of shutting them down.
That'll bring up second down. Close to 10 yards. Almost no gain on that play. They put it again on the 19. Hawaii trying to find the right combination defensively. Trying to rotate the defensive lineman. Triple wide receiver. Lyman, Orton, and Bryant. They're all to the right. Taylor is to the left, number 33. Painter to throw. Throws to the end zone. That's caught. Touchdown. And it's the tight end again. Keller. 19-yard touchdown pass. It is the third touchdown pass of the game for Curtis Painter. And it gives Purdue an opportunity to take the lead again.
You could see that play develop right from the very beginning. Nice job by Dustin Keller. He bananas his route into the center of the field, away from the defender on the outside of him for that touchdown.
Four touchdowns on the season now for Keller. His second of this game. Summers for the point after. It is good. And Purdue in the lead, 28-27. Hawaii has been unable to stop this juggernaut of Purdue in the second half. And what is, I think, most troublesome for Hawaii fans is that Purdue is using the same kind of offense that Hawaii uses, albeit the tight end. But the same kind of spread offense. And once in a while, they'll give it to Sheets, as Hawaii once in a while gives it to Ilawa. But Hawaii, who sees this offense every single day in practice, has been unable to react to it in the second half.
Well, one of the things that we've seen over and over and over again is the tight end hurting this Warrior defense. And it's probably because they don't practice against any effective tight end during their regular week, because the Warrior offense doesn't use a tight end.
After next week's game, Miss Ariel Chung, Chief Executive Officer of the University of Hawaii Federal Credit Union, will present each Warrior senior with a plaque to honor his commitment and success as University of Hawaii student athlete. Purdue leading, kicking off his summer. Ball is taken by Ross Dickerson. Dickerson leaps over a man at the 20, gets to about the 24.
Colt Brennan looked pretty pumped up after that last touchdown pass. Let's see how he comes out and moves this Warrior offense.
Brennan with 49 touchdowns on the season. It took a while for him to throw that touchdown pass. He did so to Dickerson last trip up the field. So here comes Hawaii. They trail by one. They need this game. The most important game of the season. They just have become nationally ranked. They don't want to make it a one-week affair. Brennan throws sideline. That is incomplete. Dropped by Jason Rivers. Second down and 10 from about the 24.
At 7:07 left to play in this ball game, Hawaii's in a position they've not been in all year long, especially at home. That's trying to close out a ball game. Most of the time, right about now, we're talking about Tyler Gronke coming in to replace Colt Brennan. But right now, Hawaii down a point on their home turf, having to work for it. See how it turns out.
Again, that four-man front for Purdue. Brennan gives it to Ilawa, gets the block, tripped up, breaks the tackle, still on his feet at the 30, and short of the first down, able to get out. Now they're claiming a fumble, and they give it to Purdue. That's the second time that Ilawa has turned it over. We could not see the fumble from up here, that's for sure.
Boy, you just cannot turn it over in a game like this. Hawaii with its third turnover of the second half. That will just gut you every time. We didn't see it because Ilawa was kind of caught in the pile, but you kind of see it there. The ball popped out.
Boy, Hawaii just cannot afford to make these mistakes.
The game is in the balance right now. 6:50 left. The game is in the balance. Lyman to the far side. Credit Purdue. They were down 17 to nothing at halftime. And Hawaii is going to challenge.
Well, it sure looked like it popped out straight down to me before Nate was stopped, unless they can find a whistle there or something.
Hawaii is challenging the ruling on the field.
Eight to 27 in favor of Purdue. Let's take another look here. The ball still in his hand.
You're going to see it bounce off the turf. Right there.
See it?
Right there. The ball's out. You can barely see it right there.
Yeah.
Between his legs.
There.
On the turf. His knee. Where's his knee?
His knee's not down.
And now it's down. That's a good call. And Purdue should have it. It behooves the Hawaii defense that if they were able to stop a team of this potential, they have got to do it now.
Well, you got to wonder what was in the Gatorade that Purdue drank at halftime, because they have come out in the second half like gangbusters. They were shut out in the first 30. So far in the second half, four possessions, four touchdowns. They have got Hawaii reeling. This Hawaii defense, this makes or breaks your season right here. It's as simple as that.
And the tight end really has wreaked havoc.
After review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. First down.
That's a timeout burn for Hawaii. And as both you gentlemen said, this is what we call gut check time. This is what you're made of. 6:55 left. What is the Warrior defense made of?
Well, they need a turnover. Something fierce. They need Purdue to put the ball on the turf big time.
6:55 left. Taylor is the tailback behind the Painter. And again in that shotgun. Boy, the Hawaii defense just has been at times porous to the passing. Third down conversions time and time again for Purdue. And on the last touchdown play, it was to Orton, and he was behind everybody. Keller also, the tight end. Keller with two touchdowns, Orton with one touchdown reception. Excellent field position for Purdue on the 32-yard line of Hawaii. End zone. It is caught. Touchdown, Purdue. Lyman over the top of Gerard Lewis.
I believe that was Myron Newberry, Jim.
No, it was Newberry. You're right. It was Newberry.
And he had really good position, good coverage. That was just difference in height and jumping ability.
Yeah, that boils down to a 6'4 lineman working off a 5'8 Lewis. And what Purdue, boy, they just made it look way too easy right there on Hawaii.
Myron Newberry was the defender on that play. Newberry. Yeah, Newberry gets torched in the end zone. It is now 34-27. Summers kicks it for Purdue. And it is 35-27. So Hawaii is up against it now, but they have time, 6 minutes and 50 seconds, and they have an offense that can score in a hurry. But it is the defense that has let them down here in the second half. Take another look at this.
What beautiful, beautiful fake. And that's just height right there.
So Lyman with a touchdown pass, and that is the fourth touchdown pass in this game for Curtis Painter. It's the most points scored by Purdue in the second half this season. They scored 34 against Indiana State, and now they have scored 35 here in the second half.
And the most touchdown passes for Curtis Painter in a game this year. He had three against Ball State. He's got four tonight on 26 of 37 passing, 333 yards. And, boy, he has just come in here and just outplayed Colt Brennan. But Colt gets the ball back. And we'll say it again, this is a game of epic proportions for Hawaii.
Kicking is Summers into the end zone and out of the end zone. Hawaii will start at the 20-yard line. Purdue down 17 to nothing. I mean, it's like two different worlds here. And all of a sudden, Hawaii is looking at their watch, and they're looking at the coach that brought them to the dance. And the watch is just short of striking 12.
Hawaii's been their own worst enemy with the slew of turnovers here in the second half. It's aided Purdue working with a short field. And the Boilermakers have taken advantage. Well, Hawaii's, they have to answer it right now.
Aiea is in the backfield along with Brennan. So Brennan throws, and that's tapped again. Cliff Avril, either went off Avril or it went off Maui'a.
Avril blocked it, I believe. I don't understand why the officials aren't blowing the ball as soon as it hits the ground and waiting until a defender actually picks it up to blow the whistle.
Second down and 10 from the 20.
I guess they had to think about it.
That's the fourth time that a Brennan pass has been tipped in this game. Second and 10. Brennan steps up. Keeps the ball. Throws it. That is complete to Bess. And Bess gets out to about the 24. Hawaii's receivers are not open. And Brennan has really had to scramble, literally scramble, just to get the ball out of his hands.
The one thing you notice about the Boilermaker defensive line is compared to the other ones we've seen for the last month, month and a half, is they're very quick. And they have good speed. So if they can get past their linemen, the offensive linemen, they really move quickly towards the quarterback.
Big third down play. Third down and long six for Hawaii. Triple wide receiver to the left. Huge play for Hawaii. Brennan, shovel pass. This is Maui'a. First down, 35-yard line. Trying to hold on to it. And he gets to the 40. 16-yard gain on a first down. Hawaii converts on that big third down situation.
Well, that's a great play call by Hawaii, because when Maui'a gets this ball, there's nothing but open green turf in front of him. And he runs for about 10 yards before anybody makes contact. And that's exactly what Hawaii needed right there. As you take a look at it, he's got wide open spaces in front of him, plus a blocker.
329 yards now for Brennan. That sets the single season mark in yardage. Brennan back to pass. Looks, throws sideline. Throws it high. Incomplete. Was intended for Devon Bess. And for the first time in a long time, we have seen Brennan throwing under pressure, throwing in a hurry, not really letting the pattern ripen to where he's the most effective. Second down and 10 from the 40. 5:47 left.
On that last play, Chad Mock might have been the receiver to hit. He was streaking down the field. He was just about ready to get past his coverage. If Colt could have winged it, that might have been a big game.
Second down. Brennan steps up, throws over the middle. That is caught. Caught by Bess. On the 33-yard line. And Bess steps away from the defensive carnage and struts back to the huddle. 27-yard gain.
What can you say? Throwing into triple coverage again. But that's the Colt Brennan we've watched game after game after game. Threading the needle. Nice job. Nice throw by Colt.
Bess, another terrific night of football. Six catches, 117 yards. First down for Hawaii. Ball is at the 32 of Purdue. Brennan throws. That is complete to Jason Rivers. Rivers gets to the 10.
Well, the Boilermakers brought the house on that play, but weren't able to get to Brennan before he was able to get the ball for a 22-yard gain.
Royce Adams made the stop.
And that's the side of the field they need to go to. In certain situations, when Hawaii comes out with three wide receivers, Purdue puts a freshman, Royce Adams, out by himself. He's out here again on the near side facing Ian Sample.
It is still Malia in the backfield along with Brennan. And we have
a legal substitution, I believe.
12 men on the field for Purdue. They tried to get the man off, but they could not do it.
So that's on Purdue. That'll move the ball.
Illegal substitution. Defense.
That'll move the ball to the 5-yard line as you look at Joe Tiller. Joe Tiller's got to be proud of the way his team has played here in the second half. Hawaii spreads the field. First down, goal to go. Brennan looking, touchdown, throws, touchdown! Ryan Bryce Mullen, Hawaii comes right back.
They're going to go for two, I believe. It's 33-35. This is the time to do it.
That is Colt Brennan's 50th, 5-0, his 50th touchdown pass this season.
Boy, Hawaii's done a good job of helping keep Purdue in this thing by turning the ball over. That time, Purdue did their job to keep Hawaii in it because that was blown coverage to allow Bryce Mullins to come across the middle, and he was wide open. And so Hawaii goes for two to try to tie this baby up with 4:40 left.
Hawaii comes out again in the spread for 2 points to tie the game. They do it. Ryan Bryce Mullins. He scores the touchdown. He catches the 2-point conversion. And we are even.
You take being active.
Central Pacific Bank sponsors the Loyalty Award by donating $100 for every touchdown Hawaii scores. $400 tonight.
Well, this 42, 44, 45,000 crowd is going crazy.
This is what Hawaii has to contend with. Painter, Curtis Painter, this half, 15 of 18 passes, 200 yards, and 4 touchdowns. Hawaii has not been able to solve it. Bryant and Sheets are deep. And the real football game starts right now with 4 minutes and 40 seconds left. This crowd in a frenzy.
You get the feeling that if Kaikalama Francis, Mel Purcell, Leonard Peters, all the team leaders on defense, all over there talking it up with their teammates. They need a stop and they need one bad.
Kickoff is deep. It will not be returned by Dorian Bryant. Hawaii, 80 yards in 7 plays, 2 minutes and 2 seconds of elapsed time. Brennan to Bryce Mullins from 5 yards out, and then Brennan to Bryce Mullins for the 2-point conversion. And we are tied at 35.
Boy, Purdue, 35 points in the second half, 21 in this fourth quarter. We have 4 minutes and 43 seconds left to play in this fourth quarter. They've already scored 3 times in the quarter. The Hawaii defense needs to come up with a big play, and they need it right now.
They come out on the Hawaii offense. The wides. The shotgun. The throw complete to Bryant. Gets by Patek. Gets into the secondary. And comes out to the 30-yard line. That could be enough for the first down.
A little bit confusion there on the Warrior defense. They actually had 12 men on the field, but they were able to run the player off before the snap of the ball.
Adam Leonard made the stop on the play. Ball is out to the 30-yard line.
It was heads up by Monk and Malala to get off the field. I guess they wanted to be in the nickel back coverage. And they needed to get a linebacker out of there, but he ran off the field and saved the penalty.
Painter is 11 for his last 11. Pitch to the near side. Sheets. Sheets to the 34. That'll bring up second down and 6. The clock. 3:57 and ticking. Michael Malala coming up from the secondary to make the tackle for Hawaii. Purdue is in no hurry.
Well, the golden rule is when you're on the road, you don't want to play for overtime. You want to try to win it outright in regulation.
Lyman and Bryant to the far side. Keller, the tight end. Painter, sack! Blaise Suarez, second sack of the season for Suarez. Hawaii's defense showed up at just the right time. That'll bring up third down, however. Third down. And Purdue has been able to convert on third down throughout this second half. Hawaii must rise to the occasion. Painter comes out into the huddle.
Hawaii offense. We've been talking about it. Dangerous on third and long all season long, but so is this Purdue offense. Huge, huge play in this ballgame.
Purdue is 6-for-6 in the last third down conversion. Painter looking, throwing, intercepted. Hawaii intercepts it. Gerard Lewis at the 45-yard line.
Plays in a row, the Warriors top two linebackers in there. They do it again, get pressure on Painter. Painter throws up a bad pass, it's intercepted. Nice play by Gerard Lewis.
It was intended for Bryant. Hawaii with a golden opportunity. You talk about storybook, you talk about plot line, you talk about outstanding game stories. All of that starting to take shape here. The clock, 2:27 left. We're tied at 35.
This is where you prove you're number 25 or better in the country.
Well, the crowd helped out on that one. This place was rocking.
Biggest crowd of the year. The best crowd of the year. Brumman steps up, throws, complete. First down. With it is Jason Rivers.
Speaking of crowd, Jim, the tickets issued tonight, 47,825 turnstile, 44,298. Hell of a crowd.
Where have you been?
glad you're here.
All is on the 41-yard line of Purdue.
Yeah, those 3,000 no-shows are still out trying to get into the stadium parking lot.
First down for Hawaii. At the 41-yard line of Purdue, again, the four-man front. They have pressured Brennan. He steps up. He throws long. He wants the touchdown. Man open. Off the fingertips. Jason Rivers. Terrell Vinson covering on the play for the Boilermaker.
That was the play that we saw a little bit before on the last drive. And just a little bit out of Jason Rivers' reach.
2 minutes and 4 seconds left here in this fourth period, tied at 35. Bess comes out wide to the left. Sample wide to the right. Now Rivers on the wing of Bess to the left side, the short side of the field. Second down and 10 from the 41. Brennan looking left, now throws. That is complete. Inside the 30-yard line with it is Jason Rivers. And Rivers has a first down at the 27-yard line. The clock, 1:56 left. 14-yard gain.
Well, that
already, Dan Kelly has kicked a 52-yarder.
They're definitely inside range of Dan Kelly at this point right now.
Brennan has gone over 400 yards again.
And every time a Hawaii receiver gets that ball out in the flat, you're just hoping, you're watching them hoping that they hang on to that thing.
First down for Hawaii. Ball just short of the 27. Brennan rolling, looking, in trouble, looking for blockers. He's going to run, tucks it in, gets it to about the 21-yard line.
I think at the point where he was rounding the corner, he had to run because he didn't know if any Warrior offensive linemen were downfield, and it stopped the clock, so that's a double good.
And it was looked like he was very close to the line of scrimmage. And good composure by Brennan because he had Grice Mullen breaking deep in the flat. And he chose not to throw out there. and he stops the clock with 1:34 left.
Here comes this offense. June Jones has said repeatedly, Hawaii needs to play with a short lead as well as a big lead. Well, tonight they have to prove it. Quick pass. This is complete to Sample. Sample at the 10. Sample at the 5. Touchdown!
Listen to that crowd. How do you say happy? They need to make this extra point, though, and that's been an interesting effort all year.
What Sample catches this on one side of the field, he'll bring it all the way back across the other side. One thing this Hawaii receiving unit can do is block. He got a bunch of blocks from his receiving teammates right there. Takes it in, and Hawaii regains the lead.
51st touchdown pass of the season for Brennan. Forrester in to try the extra point. And he boots it up. It's good. Boy, that was a low snap again.
Outside to his right-hand side. He had to bring it back around. The Warriors make these extra points just way too interesting. But it's 40, a good job on their part for getting it.
It's 42-35. Still, a minute 27 left to play.
You're watching that play again by Ian Sample. That's the play that another nickname for it is jailbreak, because people are going all over the place. You can see that he lets the blockers get out in front of him, and he slides in behind him and across the field. Touchdown. Great job.
Boy, it's taken a while, but the magic is back at Aloha Stadium. We're up in the rusty press box.
A little nervous.
And this place is rocking. I mean, the crowd is literally shaking. You can see it in that shot right there. All of our cameras are shaking. This place is going absolutely bananas.
Dan Kelly in the kickoff. Hawaii leading 42-35 over Purdue. A team that has proved to be almost unstoppable in the second half until Hawaii was able to answer back.
You kind of get the feeling here that everything for the next minute 27 Hawaii does has to be perfect. Kelly has to kick this and keep it in bounds, and the defense needs to come out and make another set of plays.
Hawaii fans are on the edge of delirium here. Bryant will not return it. Bryant able to get the touchback.
We know nobody could say it was home cooking. There's Pac-10 officials all game long. They've called it fair both ways. So, you know, the way you look at this, it's been a great game. You'll see how it ends up in the next minute and 22 seconds.
The most truthful thing you can say right now, it's not over yet. Colt Brennan, by the way, needs three more touchdown passes to set the all-time record in the NCAA for touchdown passes in a season. Painter, back to pass. Goes over the middle, crossing pattern. This is Bryant trying to get to the outside. He angles back and loses yardage. But they will give him forward progress only to the 21. A minute left. 59 seconds left.
Timeout on the field.
Purdue has all three of their timeouts remaining. The officials are in conference. Referee is Jack Wood. Here's Mr. Wood.
Timeout. Purdue. Their first charge timeout of the half. Please reset the game clock to 105. 105.
So from 50 seconds, they're going to go back to 105.
The timeout must have been called over here on the sideline, on the Purdue sideline. And by the time the word got out to the head official to shut it down, 7 or 8 seconds had burned off. They can go ahead and set it back.
This game was a test for Hawaii. This game was to see whether Hawaii deserved number 25. This game was against one of those power conferences, one of those BCS conferences, one of those teams that struts around, and for good reason. They're good teams in that conference. And people were saying the only way that Hawaii can prove their mettle, the only way that they can take their place among the nation's elite, is to play these kinds of teams. And tonight they have. And it has been one that people will not forget for a long time. And it is not over yet.
You know, I guess for a little while, the Western Athletic Conference would say that they are a BCS conference because in all likelihood, Boise State finishing undefeated today probably gets them into the Fiesta Bowl. But Hawaii with far bigger things on their mind right now, namely the Purdue Boilermakers.
Hawaii with only a three-man front. Low snap. Painter throws over the middle. That's complete to Bryant. And Bryant has the first down at about the 32-yard line. Blaise Suarez in the game. And he was able to twirl Bryant to the turf. Clock is stopped with a minute left. Painter, another low snap. Sideline pattern. That's intercepted. And this game is over. And Hawaii's going to win it. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. And you know what this crowd is saying? You know what it's saying? Excuse me while I kiss the sky. Adam Leonard with the interception.
Well, you got to feel for this Hawaii defense to come up with a huge play right where they need it. Adam Leonard's been a great ball player for this team all year long. Comes up with a big pick right when they needed it. And boy, this crowd, it was shaky for a little while, but it looks like at this point they're going to go home a happy bunch.
It just shows you how heads up Adam Leonard is. He looked around and decided, you know what, I'm just going to sit down. There's 53 seconds left on the clock, only two timeouts. I don't need to take a chance of even fumbling this thing. Great job.
Now Cole Brennan goes under center where he's been maybe, 10 plays all year long. The exchange. Oh, looks like he's going to stay back in the gun.
So maybe June Jones called the timeout. Leonard with that interception. For Leonard, that's his first interception of the year. Remember, he has the fumble recovery against New Mexico State that he ran in from 20 yards out. So he has had a wondrous year. Referee is saying something, but we can't hear him. Bank of Hawaii presents our choice for tonight's most valuable player. Oh, it's got to be Painter. It's got to be Chris Painter. 357 yards, 4 touchdowns. He was 29 for 42. At times, he was simply brilliant. Brilliant. But he has been intercepted twice. Colt Brennan has been intercepted once, but he again, 3 touchdowns. He now has 51 for the season, 434 yards. He was 33 for 48. 2 outstanding performances by nationally prominent quarterbacks. And for Colt Brennan, you've got to start considering him now at least as a finalist for the Heisman. He does it again. And he will take a knee.
Boy, what a difference for Joe Tiller. The last couple of times he's faced this Hawaii team, he's a coach of Wyoming, 52-6 and 66-0.
And I was there at the 66-0 game. Russ, they shoot this cannon after every score and extra point. They ran out of ammunition.
But what a great win for Hawaii. Look out, June. Here comes the water bucket. Oh, they got him.
So Joe Tiller, who didn't want to play this game, didn't want to come all this way. It was too humid. It was Thanksgiving week. We'll go out and he will shake hands with June Jones because his team, for a team that didn't want to be here, they were terrific.
And in the money quarter, the fourth quarter, Purdue, we talked about them scoring 21 points. Hawaii answered with 22, just enough to get the job done. What a wild fourth quarter.
So Hawaii against Purdue comes down a storybook finish. I mean, it was off the charts. This was the game of the year. We thought it would be, and it turned out to have all kinds of nooks and crannies, all kinds of speed bumps along the way for both teams. But when it was over, It was sweetness and light for the home team, the University of Hawaii. This Red Star moment is sponsored by Heineken. It's all about the beer Heineken. Clock is ticking down. The game is tied. Hawaii has a chance following an interception by Adam Leonard. The pass is complete to Ian Sample. He waits for his blockers. He goes behind the wedge. He gets to the outside. One final block, and joyously he trots into the end zone with what proves to be the winning touchdown in this great game. And there you see June Jones talking to his players after a maximum effort on the part of both teams. Red Star moment sponsored by Heineken. Gentlemen, this is our last football telecast of this season. We've seen just an outstanding season of football. We wish this team well. They play Oregon State next week, and then they go into the Hawaii Bowl, and I know that Jim Donovan is very, very proud of that. But thanks for joining us, Jim.
Yes, thank
and,
you.
And also Russell Yamanoha. Russell Yamanoha will continue his fine work at KTNL News 8. And I want to thank both of you for coming up here to the booth and making this year very, very interesting.
Jim and Russ, thank you very much for letting me join you for the last 9 wins, getting here on the 4th game of the season. It's truly been a magical season. If they can continue this for 2 more games, it'll be the best ever.
And Jim, congratulations. Jim Donovan, congratulations on this Hawaii team getting into your bowl game, because this is an exciting bunch. We talked all year long about how this Hawaii offense can get it done when they need to. They scored the last 15 points of this ball game to put the baby to bed. And boy, this house is rocking tonight. And what a way for us to go out on the K5 side, on the pay-per-view side. And what a way for us to go out. This is a great ball game tonight by Hawaii.
Hawaii wins it tonight. They win it in a storybook game. They win it in a game that will not be soon forgotten. Hawaii may be entering a new age. It may be considered among the teams in the country that are of the elite status. It may be.
And all of this momentum built up tonight will last for exactly 1 week.
But probably 22, 23, 24 in the country, which is pretty cool for the Warriors.
Hawaii wins it 42-35 over Purdue. Until next time, this has been another exclusive sports presentation of K5, the home team. Malama Pono, Ke Kahi, Ke Kahi.